He's a big-time shot maker. We'll have to throw some different looks at him. But, you know, you're not going to stop him. You just hope you can contain him enough to, you know, give yourself a chance in the last 4 or 5 minutes of that game.
So, Greg, one last thought. Much has been made of the fact that the Big East only got three teams in, and yet here you are, all three in the Sweet 16. You're 6-0. You went in the 12-4 in the tournament last year. Do you feel like the committee jammed the conference, and would an apology or at least an acknowledgement that maybe they got it wrong, would that help?
Now, number one, that's not going to happen.
Right.
You know, Bruce Rasmussen, our former athletic director, was on the committee for 5 years. And then Jamie Pollard, a good friend of mine from when I was at Iowa State, was on the committee this year. And I get it. I understand it. It's a very difficult job to start with. I know that watching Bruce do it for 5 years. It's especially difficult when you have that many bid stealers in a 48-hour period that really turns the bracket upside down and you know, puts a lot of really good teams in danger of not making the tournament. Now you have to decide, all right, we get this group of 10 really good teams and only three of them are getting in. How do we do this? And you know, I wish there was a way that coaches knew, you know, what exactly are you being judged on, because it seems like you defend one team with one group of data, and then you defend another team getting in with an entire different group of data. I wish as coaches there was a way that it was a little bit more transparent, so that we understood as we build a schedule, we know what our team's going to like. Should we play a tough schedule? Should we put a soft schedule? You know, what's best for this particular team to position themselves for March? And I'm not sure those questions have been answered, and I hope they will be in the future. But obviously, we were disappointed as a league. We have a group chat with the 11 coaches, and when we only got three teams in, we were hurting for the guys that didn't get in. But those same guys have supported all of us, you know, through each one of our victories in the NCAA tournament.
I get it. Greg McDermott, 14 years now with Creighton, and they've got another great opportunity ahead of them. They've got Tennessee in the Sweet 16 Friday in Detroit. Greg, appreciate you always coming on the program and always showing up like that. Good luck this weekend. It's going to be a great one. Looking forward to it.
I appreciate it, Jim. Thanks much.
Thank you, Coach. Thanks for playing through it. Greg McDermott, that is a damn good coach. That is such a good coach. One of my favorite coaches. Really good. He's locked in, and he knows exactly what he's doing. Rick Barnes, contrary to what some of you think, damn good coach. Great matchup. One of my favorite matchups of the Sweet 16. To thank you for 40 unforgettable years, Dell Technologies is celebrating with anniversary savings on their most popular tech. Save on select next-gen PCs like the XPS 13 Plus, powered by Intel Core processors and more. Save right now at Dell.com/deals. There is your Tuesday show. My thanks to our guests, Greg McDermott, Rick Barnes, the XR4TI getting it done, clones. See you tomorrow. Thanks for listening. Have a great Tuesday. We're out. Are you a victim of the timeshare trap and think there's no way out? Well, Chuck McDowell, founder of Wesley Financial Group, has helped over 35,000 families out of financial hardship by getting them out of bad timeshares, and they may be able to help you too. If you were misled into signing a timeshare agreement that is a lifetime commitment, if you were told timeshare is a great investment or your maintenance fees will never go up, you need to get the facts about timeshare cancellation. For over 10 years, Wesley Financial Group has been dedicated to helping folks get out of a lifetime of debt by canceling their timeshares. So they created a timeshare exit information kit, which reveals how the timeshare industry works and what your options are for cancellation. Simply call Wesley right now and they will send you a timeshare exit information kit absolutely free. See how you can become timeshare free. Call 800-761-0000. That's 800-761-0000. Again, 800-761-0000.
The best burgers around. Everyone loves a thick, juicy, and fresh burger. Tiebreakers in Greenville, plus the all-new Tiebreakers in Winterville, do real burgers better than anybody. So don't just go to any burger-themed restaurant chain. It's time to break the chain and eat local. Tiebreakers, real burgers at its best.
Everybody! Everybody loves burgers.
Turkey, ham, bacon, these and other meats are great around the holidays and every other day, but they all leave behind grease when you cook them, and grease is a real pain in the drain. When you pour grease down a drain, it cools and can clog sewer lines. That can lead to sewer spills, which are messy, bad for the environment, and can also be expensive. Never pour grease down the drain. Instead, collect it in a container like a used soup can or jar. Let it cool and throw it away in the trash. Together, we can protect our sewer system and the environment. For more information, go to GUC.com.
And then it was Tuesday,
though! We're here for the booty.
Party?
Pirate Water is here. Go to drinkpiratewater.com to find Pirate Water in a location near you.
We're going places!
Pirate Water is here. 21 and older, please drink responsibly.
The wait is over. DraftKings Sportsbook, an official sports betting partner of NASCAR, is now live in North Carolina. Now you can legally bet on all your favorite sports anytime, anywhere, right here in North Carolina with DraftKings. For a limited time, new customers who sign up with the promo code PIRATE and bet $5 will receive $250 instantly in bonus bets. DraftKings has the best features, including same-game parlays, player props, and more, with fast and easy payouts right at your fingertips. Get ready for the NCAA tournament with DraftKings. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app now using the code PIRATE and bet $5 to get $250 instantly in bonus bets. Only on DraftKings Sportsbook with the code PIRATE. The crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov. 21 plus, North Carolina only. Bonus bets expire 168 hours after issuance. Deposit and eligibility restrictions apply. Terms at DraftKings.com/sportsbook/NC. NASCAR is not a sponsor of this promotion and used under license.
Okay, guys, I've devised a plan to find better home internet. Kids, you scout the web for the best deals. Honey, you monitor our projected data usage.
Or we could avoid that hassle and go with U.S. Cellular's home internet. There's no guesswork, and their internet's faster than ever.
New plan. Ellen, you sign up for U.S. Cellular home internet. Madison, you bring me snacks while I stream the game. Let's do this.
Bundle and save on U.S. Cellular's new and improved home internet. Just $29.99 when bundled with a wireless plan. U.S. Cellular, built for us. Terms apply. Visit uscellular.com for details.
In this new world of having everything delivered to your home or office, why wouldn't you start using Cellular Warehouse for all of your cellular deliveries? Toby Williams and his team are in the business of delivering phones and tablets every day to customers, which enables you to take the hassle out of visiting a store. The best thing about this great service is that it is free. Call Toby Williams today at 252-799-7051 and let his team make your wireless experience fast and easy. Cellular Warehouse, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent.
This is Talbot Green with Integrity Home Mortgage. Are you ready and pre-approved if the home you want to purchase comes for sale today? This is a very important step when trying to purchase a home in the current market. Integrity Home Mortgage offers a wide variety of loan programs. Our team of Talbot Green, Braxton Green, and Joanne Weir has over 50 years of experience and is committed to providing you with the superior customer service you deserve. To get started, call me, Talbot Green, 714-2076.
Talbot Green, NMLS, 120331, for informational purposes only. Integrity Home Mortgage Corporation is equal housing lender, NMLS 208516.
This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250 and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930 and 104.1 FM Washington.
Can you be quiet, please? Thank you.
Welcome to Pirate Radio Live.
How's everybody doing?
You already know, my guy.
I'm a current log snapper.
T-top five, man. That's all I'm going to say.
We're blue collar, we're hard workers, that's who our fans are, that's who our school is.
Cliff, what's up? It's Bryce.
Loneliness is worse than COVID. It's a proven fact.
I don't want a stalker.
Bro, what are we doing here?
Bro.
Just a bunch of dudes sitting in a room talking into sticks, man.
So you're the asshole.
You can't say that.
Cliff, thank you for letting me hijack the show.
If it wasn't funny, then let's blame it on the duck.
Now live from the Pirate Radio Studios in the heart of the Pirate Nation, here is your host, Clip Brock.
All right, welcome in to a Tuesday edition of Pirate Radio Live. Clip Brock here with you inside the Pirate Radio Studios, coming to you on Pirate Radio 92.7 FM in Greenville, 104.1. In Washington, we're on 1250, 930 online, PR927FM.com. And we'd love for you to hang out with us on Facebook Live and YouTube. Head on over to Pirate Radio TV. Give us a subscribe. Give us a like. And let us know what is on your mind on this Baseball Tuesday in Greenville, North Carolina. East Carolina taking on UNCW tonight, trying to continue their good play during the midweek and their solid play at home, coming off a losing series, but four games at home this week to make up for it for ECU, starting tonight with UNCW. So we'll talk some baseball. We had Pro Day earlier today, ECU football practice, spring ball going on, so we'll have some comments from that as well. But you'll hear what Julius Wood, Jeremy Lewis, Jalen Johnson had to say earlier today as they were performing in front of NFL scouts. So we'll have that on today's show, and a lot of basketball talk as well, as the Sweet 16 gets underway on Thursday. We'll have the games right here Thursday and Friday on Pirate Radio. Coming up, we got the Mully Man in hour number two. We got Bryce Williams in hour number three. And we got Coach Mack joining us here in hour number one to talk all things hoops. Hello, Coach Mack.
Hello, guys and gals. We will talk all things hoops. I've been busy at the women's tournament, the first couple rounds in Blacksburg. So an impressive win and a heartbreaking loss for the Hokie women. And, of course, there's lots of news on both sides of the aisle, as they say. And on the men's bracket, I still have 11 out of 16 in the going forward, which and it includes my Final Four still alive. So I'm not totally depressed.
All right. And we'll get our standings update, Coach. Let you know where you sit here at Pirate Radio.
Who does this?
Shirley, do you have the standings for our pool? Just so we can see where Coach Mack is.
Yes, sir. I think
he's in pretty good standing right now.
Coach Mack is currently tied for fifth place with 40 points.
Ooh, I'm awful.
Alex Harper, asterisk. Yeah. Because he may or may not be eligible. It is debatable.
By the way, we didn't even talk yesterday about you, Shirley, and you had, what was your, who did you have winning a game in the tournament? That wasn't in the tournament?
Yeah, but I caught it. I fixed it before the tournament started.
Okay.
It was Florida, and I had Florida State.
Okay.
And
but you fixed it before the tournament started.
Before this tournament started, because I went back and caught it. I happened to, because I was like, why does that look weird? And I went back and I looked, and sure enough, I had put Florida State instead of Florida. Coach, so I went back and marked out the state.
Alex Harper has Houston winning it all, Houston.
All right.
Are we counting that if
Houston?
They win? Houston.
Mm-hmm. Houston.
It's like a Middle Eastern country. Houston. Spell and what was your issue with Coach Mack, Shirley?
Oh, your bracket. Some of the bracket, I don't know where you got that. It's obvious you got it offline and you
right.
did it.
Yeah. And it said 2022. Yeah.
No, I didn't catch that.
Yeah.
Did it say 2022?
Yeah.
He's living in the past, man.
You had the right teams on there.
Right, but the bottom line was some of the games, like the winners that you picked, were not part of the bracket. The games were all out of order. Coach, we need to talk about this.
I'm disqualified. DQ'd.
No. You're not DQ'd because I counted what was correct. It's just you were missing some games because it had... You had two teams. I'm trying to use examples here. Let's just use Marquette and Duke, for example. Well, right beside it, you're supposed to put in who's the winner between Duke and Marquette.
Yeah.
But it was showing a completely different team. It was out of order.
You chose a weird way to do a bracket, too.
I had to type in because my writing is so bad. Maybe I should have just gone with the bad handwriting.
You know, why did you have a 2022 bracket?
Which
I didn't
know.
It was
the only blank one that I could type in.
Oh, my gosh.
I don't get it. Yeah.
Every other blank one that you could fill in yourself,
right?
You had to pay to get that program.
Oh, no, no, no. Here's what you do, because this is what I do with Wes, because sometimes I can't read Wes's handwriting either.
Oh, no, just stop. Just stop.
No, 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 no.
You
no.
got me and Wes. I'm out.
Coach, coach. No, I just read. I'm done. What I do is I read.
I'll come back next Tuesday.
You know I love you, coach. But what I do is I read off the games to him, and I tell him, okay, here are your choices. Yeah. Who's the winner? And I fill out his bracket for him, but he tells me who his winners are.
He's had some issues in the past.
Yes, all right, anyway, which is why we had to do that.
But is Coach Mac's bracket eligible and good?
It is still eligible. Right. It's still good.
I kind of want to look at it now.
You got to look at it because it. I mean, my brain completely jumped the tracks trying to read it.
All right. There
Sorry,
you go.
Coach.
Sorry, Coach Mac.
As the official scorekeeper of our bracket challenge. My brain hurt looking at it, and I had no clue that was a 2022 bracket. No clue.
Let me check in with the chat gang real quick. Robert is in, says, hello, Pirate Radio. Hope your Wednesday show is a great one. Well, thank you.
Yeah, that would be tomorrow.
But, hey, I'll take it.
Okay.
We'll take a good great Wednesday show.
Sure.
Jerry is asking folks to smash the like. Thank you, Jerry. PJ says, hello.
Smash that like button.
Jamie is in. Hey now, says come on, eat Pirate Baseball, need another winning streak.
I sure do. Mm-hmm.
Young Joey in the YouTube chat. What's Joey. Up, Joey?
Joey.
Good to see your avatar. Austin says, Joey, how's my favorite Counting Crows doppelganger doing? Matt and Hadley are checking in. Hello, Matt and Hadley. Tyler says, so Auburn, Coach Mac? Question mark.
I'm not responsible for Auburn, just so you know.
Well, I picked him thinking
that I had something to do with him.
Yeah.
No, Bruce Pearl has been infinitely unlikable during this whole thing. Plus, they are so weird to watch. They play really, really hard.
Yeah.
But
but not really good.
Chaotic. Some nights they're wonderful, and some nights they're just awful. And Yale beat them, so that'll tell you all you need to know.
Joey,
I'm looking at my bracket, and it makes 100% sense.
Yeah, I don't know.
There are two teams playing, and one team advances. There are two teams playing, and one team advances. I don't understand.
Okay, yeah. I need to look at it.
It doesn't make
eyes.
Good radio to talk about a bracket that you have to look at.
Zach says we need coaches take on each of the Sweet 16 betting lines. Yes, we certainly do.
Zach, you know, and you've set this up because you've, you know, talking about me being undefeated.
Yeah.
I'm only undefeated when the lines are just completely off.
Right. And that's a skill.
Yeah. But
and we're not going to. We're not going to do a Coach Mac pick
segment. I lost a couple followers because I picked the wrong team or something. They criticized after the fact.
Well, we're not doing a every game line. We're just going to do if Mac sees one that's way off, hammer it like the Chattanooga women. I watched pretty much that entire game on Saturday.
I wish I got a percentage of the text messages I got after that game.
You were all over it though.
I'd have skipped this show.
So yeah, all right, we'll run down some lines. Eric said, even with the wrong games, Coach Mac still managed to beat Chandler's bracket. And no matter how wonky your bracket is, it's better than Chandler's.
This is the bar right there for that.
Coach Mac's doing the too little on you, Kenny. Your score's too little. Have I introduced you? Oh, Chandler, welcome in.
Hey, it's been 9 minutes of the show.
I wonder what he was pouting about. I didn't know what the heck it was.
No, Coach, it's just I have good radio etiquette, and I do not speak until I am introduced.
You started that today?
No, I've always done that.
Oh,
Coach Mac, Mike P says if you have bad handwriting, just write the seed in. Do that from now on.
Yeah, I could. Well, maybe. I don't even know that I can write numbers that well.
Then if you have a one versus
the abbreviation of the school.
Yeah, I tried that.
A one versus a one in the final four of the championship. Just put one and you could say, well, that's the team I meant right there. Jamie says, Coach, you lost followers because you blocked them, not because of your picks. Could be. Could very well be. And Mike P says, more like Deuce Pearl because Auburn pooped the bed against Yale.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mike P. Appreciate that. All right, where to begin on this tournament? Is there a As I said yesterday, every tournament is unique, Coach Mack, and we thought last year we had the narrative of, all right, NIL transfer portal, it's just going to be crazy every year. It's so much parity, you're going to have San Diego State and FAU in the Final Four. Well, this year, the big boys had something to say. You got all number one and number two seeds in the Sweet 16. Still could be some craziness with NC State if they try to continue this thing, but it looks like we're going to have some great teams and some great games coming up here. So how about this tournament with the big boys taking a stand here?
Yeah, are there out of the 16, are there like two non-power fives or something like that? Or maybe non-power sixes if you count the Big East?
So you've got San Diego State.
There's one.
Gonzaga is a power school from a non-power conference.
No. That's two.
We're counting the Big East as one of the big conferences, right?
Yes.
Okay. So there's all those teams. And that is it.
So two.
Yeah.
So 14 out of the 16 are power six teams, if you will.
Yeah, and both of those schools have staying power in this tournament. San Diego State went to the championship last year, Gonzaga.
Yeah, yeah, for a minute San Diego State was going to be in the Pac-12 last year, and Gonzaga was going to be in the Big 12 as a basketball only member. So it would have been 16 out of 16 had things turned out a little bit differently till the SEC decided us along with the Big 10 are going to kill the Pac-12.
I wonder why why Gonzaga has stuck where they have. Is that their choice, or they are not sought after enough?
No, I'm not sure anybody is willing to accept them on their terms. They have a unique deal in the conference they're in. They get to keep all their money. They get a disproportionate share of the television package. They are more well funded. They were like Texas in the old Big 12 where they had their own deal. They've got their own deal out there, so it makes it a little bit more palatable for them to just stay there.
So they don't share equally like every other team would.
No.
Interesting. And then if like Pepperdine makes it one year, they have to give all their money to Gonzaga, right? Is that
how, is that it's how not it quite that bad, but but close.
All right, so upsets. We did not get a ton of them, Coach. We talked about Auburn. The NC State run, is that even an upset at this point? Of course, Kentucky.
I don't think so.
What'd you make of Kentucky going down first round?
That was an upset for sure, and that's still going on. I guess Cal met with Mitch Barnhart, the AD, today to talk about what they need to do going forward. But at some point, I guess even the Power Two schools have to consider money, and a $33 million buyout is a pretty steep check to write. But I don't know. What do you guys think? I mean, obviously they're underachieving for the resources that they have, but does it all fall on Coach Calipari?
Yeah.
So would you fire him if you're the AD?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, I used to go into my boss, Sonny Smith, and said, we got to get rid of this guy. He said, that's fine. Who are you replacing him with?
You're at Kentucky. You can replace him with whoever you want.
Who would you replace him with?
I don't have a name.
Who can
for you
get?
Right,
that's the problem. It's easy to say fire the guy.
I know. I knew you were going there.
Well, I mean, that's part of this whole back and forth. You can't just say, I'm firing the guy. You can't say it. That's not allowed.
Fair enough. Well, by the end of this hour, I'll have a name for you.
But,
okay, so for right now, no, you can't fire him.
Okay, and it's got to be somebody you can realistically get.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. There's my challenge to the...
I said Shaka.
No.
Is that a realistic...
Because before this weekend...
The guy who failed miserably at Texas?
Before this weekend, the Shaka, you couldn't get to the Sweet 16. They finally did.
That's true.
Yeah.
I know they had one Final Four run, and then I think... Is this the first Sweet 16 he's been in since then?
Since VCU.
Since VCU?
Yes.
Yeah. So, but, I mean, yeah, you could do this with all these guys as far as... Kelvin Sampson can't win the big one until he can. Matt Painter can't until he can. Rick Barnes can't until he can.
Yeah, he's always gotten killed in March.
I have a question.
Until this year when he wins it all.
I have a question for you, Coach.
Okay.
Because I'm seeing a lot of it discussed on social media, Facebook, Twitter. But the discussion really all year was the ACC is having a down year.
Yeah.
Did the ACC? I know you were going to do this. I don't think this. but I want to get his perspective on it. I knew you were going to act this way.
I haven't
so
said
calm
anything.
Down. Oh, no, just calm down. I knew you were going to do this. Did the ACC prove the people wrong by having four teams in the Sweet 16?
No, this is like comparing bowl records. It's a whole different thing. It depends on the matchups that you get. No, I mean, the ACC still had a down year. Virginia Tech was not very good. They went 10-10. They were a 500 team in the league. Virginia got in the tournament, and look what they did. Are we going to judge them by what Virginia did? No, it's great for the ACC. I'm glad, you know, as a Virginia Tech fan, that the league is having some success with four people in the Sweet 16. But no, this doesn't change. This doesn't drastically change the narrative, in my opinion.
Yeah, I mean, because I agree as well that the ACC had a down year. It's just so many people on social media, especially Facebook, these yeah. Carolina State fans are, you know, saying like, oh, the ACC is just fine. Like, look at us having four teams in the Sweet 16. That's why I was like, I knew you. I was going to get a reaction out of you. But I do agree with you in your explanation of it.
Does what? Clip disagree?
I don't like the whole conference. Yeah. Like, yeah. We know Carolina and Duke are good. That doesn't make Georgia right. Tech good. I don't like the whole conference thing, especially now. What Clemson has done thus far is very impressive.
Yeah.
New Mexico stunk. That was Wager's pick of the first round, so road to a dead-end road on that one with them. But what they did to Baylor the other day, very impressive. That was a wire-to-wire, wall-to-wall win, even when Baylor made a rally at the end of that game.
I'm a big PJ Hall fan.
I heard somebody say... that Brad Brownell will get an extension, and then they'll like miss the tournament next year, and 2 years from now he'll be on the hot seat. Like
he'll make the tournament again and make it run.
Yeah, and then he's on the hot seat, and then they'll win more games in the tournament.
Brad is Dabo's good friend. He's just fine.
He's good.
He's fine.
And I believe
this is just a bonus thing right here.
I think he's won a. Well, it doesn't have to be true, because I think I saw he was 3-3 in the tournament. So when he goes, they win for the most part. Yeah.
Three for three is not. Of course, he was 1-3, I guess, going into this year. So,
well, no, this was on Thursday. This was before that game.
Oh, interesting.
They were 3-3.
So they're 5-3. Holy cow.
Yeah, right. So
how many people even have a winning record in the tournament?
Very good question. I'll have to look that up. All right. Mike P says, could you see Kentucky bringing back Rick Pitino? I would say no at his age. You would say?
How about Cal goes to Louisville and Pitino goes back to Kentucky? We just run it back.
So Louisville is what? Open?
Open.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, they've had trouble. Dusty May turned them down and
really?
Scott Drew turned them down.
What was the two head coaching carousel?
I said Dusty May was one of Louisville. Yeah, okay. Yeah, and that's why one of the guys stopped following me.
Then he ended up going to Michigan.
Yeah.
What do you mean? Did somebody actually say you were wrong, so I'm unfollowing you?
Yeah.
Who?
I don't know. I they're not following me. I can't look it up.
That is, are you losing sleep at night?
Not at all.
Okay. I definitely would.
It's just interesting.
And what was the other one you had?
Mark Byington to West Virginia.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and he went to Vanderbilt.
All right.
Yeah.
And
he turned down West Virginia, and they hired the guy from Drake, DeVry, I think is his name.
Well, let me ask you this, and I already know the answer. Why go to Vanderbilt instead of West Virginia?
The answer is money. What's the question?
Well, there's two answers, though. The other one is, if you're not in the SEC or Big Ten, that's one of your lines, too.
They're really the same thing.
And I swear, you are right. Like, people are flocking to these conferences, whether it be head coaches, assistant coaches, to get into these big money leagues.
Yeah, and it's
crazy.
It's going to continue. The problem is, if you're in the ACC, and I hate this for the ACC and Virginia Tech, or the Big 12, or whatever else league you want to call, you don't know what your future is. You may be included in the big picture, and you may not.
Yeah.
So
go for the sure thing.
Kenny Brooks from Virginia Tech has had a great run for women's basketball in Blacksburg. Went to the Final Four last year. Won the ACC this year. He's going to Kentucky.
He's on the move.
Man, going to the Kentucky. SEC, where there's safe ground underneath you.
Who's the front runner for the Hokies job?
Good question. I don't know the answer to that. I don't know the answer to that. And one of his assistants from Chattanooga, we were discussing this earlier, just got the Clemson job, or will get the Clemson job tomorrow, actually.
There you go. Mac McCarthy joining us, Pirate Radio Studios. It is Ticket Tuesday, brought to you by Toby Williams and Cellular Warehouse. Today we are giving away a pair of tickets to ECU versus UAB for Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. So we'll have a pair of tickets to those games coming up this weekend, beginning on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, for some Pirate Weekend Series baseball. We'll have those tickets for you later on today's edition of Pirate Radio Live. We'll take a break, come back, more with Mac, more of your questions in the YouTube and a Facebook chat. And we roll on Pirate Radio Live on a Tuesday, back with you after this.
Country music artist and comedian Rodney Carrington is coming May 4th to Weldon Mills Theater, Eastern North Carolina's best entertainment venue. Conveniently located just off I-95 in Roanoke Rapids, Weldon Mills Theater offers a hassle-free entertainment experience with free parking, wallet-friendly concessions, and a cozy atmosphere. With comfortable seating throughout the venue, there isn't a bad seat in the house. Join Weldon Mills Theater for a memorable event where you can relax and make lasting memories. Get your tickets for Rodney Carrington on May 4th at WeldonMillsTheater.com.
Southern Ease has arrived, Pirate Nation. Whether you savor the bourbon flavor or indulge in other delightful options, Southern Ease gummies are here to elevate your moments. And here's the best part. You can enjoy them with an exclusive discount. Head over to SouthernEase.com now and use the code PIRATE at checkout for a fantastic 25% off your first order. At Southern Ease, you can be living life to your fullest, one sweet moment at a time. SouthernEase.com.
This is your What's New update, brought to you by Greenville Auto World. What's new? Greenville Auto World has new owners and is part of the DriveHereNow.com team of dealerships. New owner Tommy Cook and his team have four dealerships with a fully stocked inventory, over 200 SUVs, trucks, cars, and over 50 lenders, and has financing for anybody. Get shopping today at DriveHereNow.com. Greenville Auto World, Highway 43 at Bells Fork, across from Speedway. Pirates supporting pirates.
Save a load on a new John Deere compact utility tractor and loader from Quality Equipment. It's never been easier to get the best brand on the market at an unbeatable cash price, or with great financing at our lowest ever monthly payment. Now is the time to get that tractor package you've been dreaming of to get your next job done right. Stop by one of our 36 locations in North Carolina, South Carolina, and Virginia, or visit us online at qualityequip.com.
When you walk through the doors of Villa Verde, you'll experience the sights, sounds, and smells of authentic Dominican flavors. This is Jay from Villa Verde inviting you to come by and try one of our amazing empanadas, our famous red snappers, grouper bites, seafood paella, Cuban sandwiches, and much, much more. Relax on the patio with a fresh mojito or a cold beer while enjoying one of our out-of-this-world desserts, like our rum pineapple cake or our famous tres leches. Villa Verde on 10th Street, a platform for good and a proud supporter of the Pirate Nation.
Captain Bo Brooks, what's happening at Pirate Waters Outfitters this spring?
Well, we have restocked with all new apparel from Marshware and AFCO. We got the new turtle boxes coming in the River Rock color, and I always suggest that you cook your fish in a smithy, and the new smithy is in as well. We have a fly cave in the back with all you need to catch fish on the fly, and tie your own fly wall, where we have all the accessories and products you need to tie your own flies. We are Pirate Water Outfitter on Market Street next to Breakin' Bread, home of Camacho Rod Works.
There's a common misbelief today that to make it further, you need to push yourself, that you need to give up any joy to continue your rigid routine. Or you could try another way. Take some time to enjoy life, like having a Michelob Ultra with friends, because happiness is essential to living an exceptional life. Michelob Ultra, a refreshing and balanced flavor with only 2.6 carbs and 95 calories. It's only worth it if you enjoy it. Enjoy responsibly. Michelob Ultra, Proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989.
Worth Chiropractic is your local choice for chiropractic care. Automobile accident? They'll specialize in treating automobile accidents and slip and falls while working closely with your attorney. Everyday back and neck pains or sports-related injuries? They offer safe, natural care to get you back to being you. No drugs or surgery, so it's convenient, comfortable, and cost-effective. And the first consult is free. Worth Chiropractic, two convenient locations on Arlington Boulevard. Free consultations, and they'll work with your lawyer and file your insurance. Call 1-800-BACK-DOC today.
This is John David Baker, offense coordinator for the ECU Pirates, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 1 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour is brought to you by Pirate Water. Get ready to party, pirates. Go to drinkpiratewater.com to find your new treasure. 21 and older only. Pirate Water. Why be yourself when you can be a pirate? Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Brown & Wood is your home of the best selection of GMC, Cadillac, Buick, and Mazda in Eastern North Carolina since 1937. Shop their entire inventory online at brownandwoodauto.com or visit them on Greenville Boulevard. Brown & Wood, Greenville's number one dealership and the home of the lifetime powertrain warranty. Now let's head back in to PRL. Here is your host, Clip Brock.
Back with you, Pirate Radio Live. That was a question. So we talked about conspiracies yesterday. There was a conspiracy question I wanted to ask Mac last week and I forgot. I think it's a decent question though. So only three Big East teams get into the tournament. Big East games are on Fox and not ESPN. We say, well, the tournament's not on ESPN, it's on CBS. Well, guess whose games are on CBS and CBS Sports Network? The Mountain West, who got all those teams in. Do you think there was a bias towards the Big East because their games are on Fox and not on ESPN or CBS?
I don't really, although TV really makes a lot of decisions that I don't think we're aware of. I think they've got their fingerprints all over the expansion deal, for instance. The Big East teams would have been good draws because of the population in those locations. I don't think that happened. I think the Mountain West and I think even the Big 12 to some degree. I think they played the schedule game just right and it worked out in their favor. And I think it was an anomaly. I don't think it was intentional. I really don't. And I love a good conspiracy theory.
I do think that. Less people probably see, like, just novice college basketball fans, less people see the Big East because their games are not going to be promoted on ESPN or probably even featured as much on SportsCenter because they're going to show ESPN games more so than a Providence Seton Hall highlight package.
Yeah, and you know the Fox thing over there is kind of its own world and doesn't reach as many people because it doesn't have as many platforms there as Fox 1, Fox 2, Fox 1 Sports.
They're readily available, but people have to work a little harder.
Yeah, and the cross promotion ESPN does is probably the most effective thing they do in a lot of different ways too. They can literally talk something into existence.
Yeah, if there is no news, they make the news.
Sure.
So all right, well, just wanted to throw that out there. Coach Mack, do you have any questions or topics today?
I've got lots of questions, lots of topics, right. But no, we're on your schedule today, and I'm sure we'll get to all the tournament questions, and we need to get to the women's bracket for Shirley too.
All right, we'll do that at some point. Do you want to throw out some stuff, or what do you want to do?
No, I'm
ready
good.
For your question.
I'm good. No,
you're
I'm good?
Good.
I'm good. I'm
all
good.
Right. Okay, well, fine. Let's do some fan service then and run through the lines. And play Guess the Lines with Coach Mack.
I love it.
This is for entertainment purposes or now for DraftKings purposes. Just want to ask you what you think the lines should be in these games, Coach.
Okay.
Clemson, Arizona.
Ooh.
7:09 CBS, Thursday night.
Probably as well as they've played and as gosh, I want to say more, but I think it's Arizona -2.5.
Whoa. Arizona -7.5.
Ooh.
Okay. Put a Ooh. Star by that one.
Ooh.
Ooh. What look, do you think about that one?
Look out for those Tigers.
I kind of like that.
All right. UConn and San Diego State.
Oh, gosh.
7:39.
That's a hard one.
Thursday
rematch.
Night.
Rematch from last year.
Rematch. And last year, that wasn't close. And this year, UConn is just as good. San Diego State is not as good. But golly, Ned, it's tough to put a big Who number on it? These things. 19.5.
Woo!
It is 11.5.
I wanted to say it should be about 14, but I was just trying to guess what they had it. But
so you see a blowout though?
I do.
All right.
I do. And the dangerous thing is San Diego State's pace of play. Can really that was the thing that won the Chattanooga NC State women's game. I mean, it just wasn't going to be that high score in a game.
Speaking of pace, Alabama and North Carolina total 173.5. What do you think the line is?
173.5.
Yeah.
I'm liking the over.
What do you think about the game?
Alabama's playing really good, but when Carolina wants to play defense, they're pretty good, and Alabama has never wanted to play defense, so I kind of like the Chapel Hill guys.
3.5 is the spread.
Oh, well, you wanted the spread. Yeah. Gee whiz, yeah. That's reasonable.
And interesting game here. Illinois and Iowa State. 2-3 matchup, 10:09-ish Thursday night. Where does Mac's line have this one going?
Illinois is so good offensively. Iowa State is not, but they do play good defense. Oh, I'd say 8.5.
Iowa State 8.5?
No.
Illinois 8.5?
Yeah.
Iowa State is a 1.5 point favorite.
That's nuts.
Okay.
All right. Start.
That's nuts.
That's nuts.
Illinois is the play. We've got a that's nuts from Mac McCarthy.
And I've got Iowa State going a ways, but Illinois is really good offensively, and that's pretty rare in the tournament.
Nuts, he says.
Marking that down.
Yeah. Speaking of Marquette taking on NC State, formerly coached by Mark Gottfried. Who is the favorite in this game?
Well, Marquette's certainly the favorite.
That they are.
But the fan favorite probably is NC State with the big guy in the middle. Everybody relates to the big guy.
DJ Burns.
Playing multiple instruments, saxophone, piano, bass. He plays all of them.
Has vending machines as a side hustle.
Yeah, you got to love that. He's probably taking money right out of those vending machines. I like that. Alabama had a guy. They signed a guy one time, and they gave him the key to the Pepsi vending machines, and he was raking it in.
Just absolutely raking it
in. That was a good way to – that was an NIL deal before there was actually NIL. I'd say 4.5.
All right. 6.5.
Yeah, close. Yeah. Gonzaga playing great right now. Purdue is a machine. Something's got to give in this one, Coach.
Yeah, they do. Gonzaga's good. Purdue's still got to be favored by like 8.5.
5.5. Yeah. Close enough. Yeah. Duke and Houston. Houston, I like how they say, like, oh, man, every championship team's got to get tested and have one of these games. UConn did not have one of those games.
No, not at all.
They rolled over everybody.
Exactly.
But you do see teams kind of first, second round, have a close one, and then win the championship. Houston had a they about let one get away the other night, but they are taking on a Duke team that has steamrolled their first couple of opponents.
Duke's guards are just playing really, really well, but I think Houston can guard them. If Duke can get loose on the perimeter, they could win this game, but it's probably 3.5.
4.5 is the number. And finally, Creighton, Tennessee. Which side are you on here?
Well, I got Tennessee winning the whole thing, so clearly I'm going to go with them. Creighton good offensively. It's not a blowout kind of game. 5.5, 6.5.
2.5. So Coach Mack says lean Tennessee there.
Whoa. Yeah, I think that.
All right. We're going orange. Illinois and Tennessee.
I'm definitely hammering Illinois with the that's nuts comment.
Can Mack stay undefeated lifetime on his crazy crazy odds?
We know that's not possible, but that one did surprise me, I'll tell you that.
All right, there you go. Coach Mack, his unofficial picks that we kind of walk him into anyway here on the show. All right, women's tournament. So Zach and Shirley have an exclusive bracket contest where it's just them two, and they are tied. Last night we saw some so Chandler, you gave out a pick for John Moody.
I did.
A guaranteed loser pick.
Yeah, so he gave me a guaranteed loser pick with the Hornets money line over the Orlando Magic, where they were 22-point dogs. So I had to try to give him a loser. So I gave him Alabama A&M to lose the,
or to
beat Austin Peay. They're like plus 700. They won. So I gave him another winner. So last night I said, all right, here's a no-doubter.
A no-doubt loser.
A no-doubt loser. I said, take Syracuse plus 1,800 money line over UConn. And that got close, didn't it?
And then 8-0 run late by Cuse almost had them winning that game, but they did not. So sorry, John, you lost. But saw that.
I almost gave him another winner. That almost was 3 in a row.
Didn't the Iowa game stay pretty close last night, too? What was that, West Virginia?
It ended up being 10, but
we saw some of the bigger teams have some close games.
State and Tennessee kind of got close there at the end, but State was able to pull away.
Yeah, Tennessee came back and got in it, and after a huge lead for NC State.
And then Zach, with an outrageous comment yesterday, Middle Tennessee should have beat LSU. I hear what he's saying. They're winning at halftime, but you can't say a team that won by 27 should have lost the game.
It was 31-8 on fouls.
It was also 45-37.
Right after halftime.
Yeah, in midway through the third quarter. They were up 8 midway through the third quarter and got beat by 100.
Yeah. So,
well, when most of the fouls are at that time period.
Oh, yeah.
Did you? I'm saying LSU's got a theme because of the Rice game.
Officiating has been a big story in the women's tournament, period. You know, whether it's being UConn or certainly the Iowa game was atrocious. West Virginia really got blasted, and Middle Tennessee did too. Whether it would have affected the outcome or not, I'm not sure about that. And I did have Middle, I think, upset in Louisville, but obviously I didn't have them upset in but I do think Iowa is vulnerable and will get beat either by LSU or UCLA, whoever wins that game going forward.
Has South Carolina had any issues yet?
No.
And the women's tournament, I'll say this, they absolutely have some villains. Kim Mulkey and Angel Reese. Caitlin Clark has developed into just a villain. She went from a hero to a villain. And UConn is playing so well, they're back to being villains too. Paige Beckers, who is, you know, really likable, she has turned into a villain now, hitting people in the face. She thinks she's Caitlin Clark.
She messed around and almost walked away with a triple-double last night.
Yeah,
so
she is so good. And when I talk to the WNBA coaches that I see at practices, mm-hmm. They all take Paige Beckers over Caitlin Clark as a point guard at the next level.
Hmm. Right, because Paige does it all. I mean, Caitlin is really good with assists. She's really good at finding the other players on the court. But Paige is just a completely different player.
Yeah.
She's more of an all-around player.
So who's the good guy then, if there's so many villains?
There's got to be some good ones. But, I mean, at least we get someone to root against.
Okay.
Probably Juju. Juju would be a villain player.
Yeah, and probably Hidalgo is too, except that she plays for Notre Dame, who so many people hate.
Yeah, Juju is a freshman phenom at USC.
Southern Cal, yeah.
Yeah, and she had a really good game yesterday.
What's up with Southern Cal's and Juju's?
Smith-Schuster.
Yeah. There was another one recently. Just pointing that out.
What's her last name? Watkins, I think?
Watkins.
Yeah,
yep, Juju Watkins. Yep.
All right. Well, there's your women's tournament update.
When's the Washington Post article going to be published?
I don't know, but I can't wait. You know, when somebody raises that much cane, do you have any read the article yet? And she did two things. Number one, she basically admitted, okay, there's something there because otherwise you just let it go. And second of all, she is guaranteed that even non-basketball fans are going to read that article.
Yeah,
she has guaranteed true. Circulation that day is going to go out of control.
Well, she also said that she is hiring the best
defamation
lawyer. Yeah. And is going to sue if anything untrue is in there. So now, if there is a bunch of stuff in there and she doesn't sue, we know that it's true.
They don't publish much that that doesn't withstand the legal test.
And that, not to mention that controversy follows her everywhere she goes. I mean, she was not without controversy when she coached at Baylor.
Oh, for sure.
Because, you know, it was long reported some of the issues that she had with Brittany Griner when Brittany played there, and some of the other issues that, you know, eventually, you know, caused her to take another job. So
how does suing work? So if, like, a former player tells me Coach Mack gave him $100 at practice one day, mm-hmm. and I come up here and say it, can you sue me if I'm using another person's quote?
If it was a lie.
Yeah.
You have to vet it.
I got to vet that.
Yeah.
I can't just come on here and say stuff.
Well, you do, but you can't.
Because, Mac, I've got a bombshell story about you coming out in 20 minutes. Would you like to get ahead of it?
All right.
Would you like to say
no,
anything?
No, I don't have a lawyer. Can't afford a lawyer. I would just have to call you a liar next time I'm on the show.
All right. There you go. All right. Let's take another break. We'll come back more with Coach Mac McCarthy, your questions. Hello on Facebook and on YouTube. Jamie says, no love for Mackenzie Holmes. I don't know who that is, so I can't give love. Would you like to give love to Mackenzie Holmes?
Sure.
Okay. Sure. Max giving some love to Mackenzie Holmes. I'm assuming she's an Indiana player.
Yeah, I guarantee it.
Yeah, coming from Jamie there. Excited about his Lady Hoosier Sweet 16.
Sure is.
We'll take a break, come back, more to go, hour one, Pirate Radio Live after this.
Golden Ticket Cinemas is Greenville's newest movie theater and is now open in the Greenville Grand location on Greenville Boulevard near Cracker Barrel. Experience the ultimate movie magic with their Elite experience. The Elite Theater has the largest screen in Greenville, state-of-the-art 4K laser projection, immersive Dolby Atmos sound, and heated luxury recliners. And coming soon, Eastern North Carolina's only IMAX theater. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show in style with luxurious amenities and top-notch service at Golden Ticket Cinemas.
Every March, Jersey Mike's turns money from subs into charitable donations.
And March 27th is Jersey Mike's annual day of giving, where 100% of sales from every sub are given back to the community.
And to kick off all that giving, Peter gave me an apron. I'm honored.
Looking good, Danny. We've got subs to make, though.
Yeah, now I know why you gave me the apron.
Join us Wednesday, March 27th for Jersey Mike's Day of Giving. Be a sub above.
Country Mart has been locally owned and operated for over 40 years and is your premier country store serving the best cheese biscuits and country food around. Country Mart is open every day and has two locations in Bethel on Highway 11 and in Stokes on Highway 903. Both Country Mart locations are top-of-the-line fuel stations serving Shell gas, including 93 ethanol-free high-octane gas, which is the best for all you boat owners. Country Mart, fueling you up with great food in your engines with great gasoline. Go Pirates!
Hello, Eastern North Carolina. Pitt County Schools is in the opportunity business. We open doors for every student by finding pathways to provide the best possible chance of success for each to reach their career aspirations of choice. As we head through the spring months, we will continue to guide our students for the different journeys of life preparedness before celebrating their accomplishments. We are committed to enhancing academic achievement and developing personal growth through work-based learning of our many career and technical education programs, college readiness, and saluting those who will be serving our country in the armed forces. Engaging, empowering, and elevating students to be successful citizens, workers, and leaders in a global economy remains our mission. Please visit our website today at pittschools.org. That's pittschools.org to learn how we grow minds and invest in our future through 38 schools and one community. Education is truly the key that unlocks doors of opportunity.
The Downtown Greenville Partnership brings Downtown Greenville to life. We are the organization that brings you Pirate Fest, Free Boot Fridays, Dickinson After Dark, and many other exciting events. The DGP is working hard to continue to improve the aesthetics of Downtown Greenville by adding plants, flower boxes, new LED lighting, and improved entryways. The DGP partners with the City of Greenville, Pitt County, the Chamber, ECU, and many others to make Downtown Greenville a fun, vibrant area to live, shop, eat, and play. Learn more about us at downtowngreenville.com.
Huckleburger.com.
Want a great lunch with quick service?
Huckleburger.
Need a place to dine out with the family tonight?
Huckleburger.
The fastest full-service restaurant in town?
Huckleburger.
Huckleburger is committed to three core values: highest level of customer service, high-quality delicious food, and lightning speed. The Huckleburger menu features delicious burgers, cheesesteaks, chicken sandwiches, black bean burgers, salads, and much more. Huckleburger in Greenville near Lowe's on Memorial Drive and off of 15th Street near the movie theater in Washington.
Huckleburger.
Delicious, fast, fresh, and friendly.
Hi, I'm Walker Allen Voliva, and I'm with CopyPro. CopyPro has been locally owned and operated here in Eastern North Carolina for over 50 years. CopyPro is the leader in office technology. Does your business struggle with keeping printing costs low or producing professional documents? Here at CopyPro, total satisfaction is our number one priority. We have a variety of solutions to help reduce your printing expenses and make your business more productive. Call us today at 1-800-682-6558 or online at copypro.net. CopyPro, we are the professional office systems people.
Pirate Radio.
Pirate Radio.
Pirate Radio.
You're listening to Hour 1 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour is brought to you by Pirate Water. Get ready to party, pirates. Go to drinkpiratewater.com to find your new treasure. 21 and older only. Pirate Water. Why be yourself when you can be a pirate? Now, back to the show.
And welcome back. Are you in outside sales and looking for an opportunity to increase your earning potential? Well, CopyPro has been in Eastern North Carolina for over 45 years and continues to grow each year. And they are in need of more sales professionals with a desire to potentially make a six-figure income. Do you have what it takes? Visit CopyPro.net today to submit your resume and to learn more. Now let's head back in to PRL. Here's Clip.
Back with you, Pirate Radio Live, on a fast-moving hour one here on a Tuesday with Mac McCarthy, who's, I guess your radio season is over with Virginia Tech dropping out.
It is.
Yeah. Did you enjoy this basketball season, Coach?
I did. I had a good time. Obviously, good. Virginia Tech women were good again. The men were just okay. It did a lot of their games. I started out at UVA doing their men and women. The men ended up in the tournament, although they didn't obviously have a good finish to the year in any way, shape, or form. No. The women got back into postseason play for the first time in quite a while, so they had a fairly successful year under a second-year coach. But had good games in the CAA tournament in D.C. And then anytime you're calling in the NCAA with a chance to advance, that's pretty cool. That's a lot of fun.
What happened to Virginia basketball?
The men, they didn't have enough players for continuity in the program. And Tony Bennett plays a specific, sophisticated kind of system, and plugging people in from the portal has not gone well.
Should he be fired?
No, you won a national championship, you get to stay as long as you want.
I've got my name, by the way. Calipari should be fired.
Yeah.
And they hire Jay Wright.
Oh, if you can get him. Yeah, that would
there
be.
You
take
you
him could, from TV.
You could just, there's one you could justify.
All right. That's all I wanted to hear.
Clip, you are so good.
My,
although that spreading that $100 rumor, that was bad of you.
Don't sue me, please, Coach. Do not sue me.
The best defamation lawyers in the country.
Yeah, when is that coming out, by the way?
I don't know.
I'm waiting.
I think they're,
I've been refreshing. I think the they're Washington making Post sure they're. Like
I
days.
Think they're making sure that. Yeah, you look like a slot player refreshing over there. They that's going to be interesting. I think they're making sure that there's nothing in there they could get sued for.
Yeah.
What if they had the article ready to go and then it come out that she was talking about him on the press conference? They had to go, all right, we have to delete all this.
Yeah. Can't use any of that.
They're like, all right.
I think their attorneys make sure everything is defamation proof before they put it in the paper. And not just the Washington Post. I think most papers do that, obviously.
Would you like to handle this segment?
No.
Questions?
No, I'm good.
You're not asking any questions?
No, you were ready to go.
I know, it's 3:49. It's almost time for you to go.
We enjoy your questions and topics.
Yeah. Okay. What about East Carolina basketball with the portal?
Ah, well, we have news today. Quentin DeBunje
out. As expected.
See the Tennessee guy?
Yeah. Ben Baiela.
out as expected from me. My click to pick, my pick to click this year.
He did not click.
Okay. No. So that's two.
Caleb LeCount.
Out.
Three.
Brandon Johnson.
Four.
Wasn't he the leading scorer?
Him or RJ.
Or close? Okay. Yeah. Four. Out.
Brandon Johnson is the one that hurts you.
You the know, other three do not. This portal thing is a real mess. And we knew it was going to be. We talked about it before it got instituted. And, yeah, freedom of movement is one thing. But, you know, I would have felt a lot better if they had done the freedom of movement if there was an existing reason, like if your coach left or, you know, something like that. But just to leave for the sake of leaving and to do it as many times as you can. Way the court case went, you can transfer 4 times in 4 years or 5 times in 5 years, whatever it is.
Well, the portal wasn't even a problem for East Carolina last year. In fact, it actually helped us with the additions of Bobby Pettiford and Cam Hayes. The only guy we lost was Javon Small, who went to Oklahoma State, and now he's back in the transfer portal.
And I mean, this feels like one of those cases for a number of those guys we talked about that may not have a spot here.
Are we going to call these people who go in the portal multiple times serial portalers?
We can.
You can. I mean, it makes sense. If they go, I mean, it's Cam Hayes is a serial portaler.
But as long as coaches keep bringing these guys in, like.
Well, I mean, there has to be you have to have a roster.
Yeah.
So, yeah. It's
but it's part of it now. Like I'm used to it now. It doesn't affect me now when I see these names go in. It doesn't do anything one way or the other for me.
Even with you being emotionally invested in East Carolina basketball, doesn't bother you.
Well, with ECU basketball, we invented the portal. We were the portal before there was a portal. Guys leaving all the time. So it's, again, I'm used to it.
When I was at Chattanooga, we used to joke that UTC actually stood for you can transfer to Chattanooga. It wasn't the University of Tennessee at Chattanooga. We were portaling before it was a portal.
So you were always looking sit out. For guys that were maybe at a bigger school that wanted to play or come back home.
When we recruited someone and lost them to Florida State or to Memphis or Western Kentucky or whoever it was.
You kept an eye on them?
Oh, we stayed in touch.
Oh, yeah.
We stayed in touch, and that absolutely paid off. Dang. I had an assistant coach.
Notice you only got 3 minutes the other night.
I had an assistant coach who would video ACC and SEC games and have the managers or the video guy cut out the bench scenes just to see who looked unhappy sitting over there. And this was before
they just made a 3-point basket and he's frowning.
But then that's why everything's so hypocritical. Like, you want a guy that roots on his team. Now you're going to take a bad guy on your team?
No, not a bad guy, just a disgruntled guy.
it's just funny that, like, if that guy's on your team, you're upset at him, but he's on another team. Yeah. And, hey, come on in.
But if he looks like that, he should leave.
The crazy world of college athletics.
So how much are you up on the tournament? Can you answer that on the air?
Doing my own betting, I'm probably not. Like, overall, I'm up just because I utilize the bonus bets and stuff like that. But it's been a roller coaster.
You played the system.
Since then. I played the system originally, yeah.
Yeah.
And that worked big. Now that you have to actually make correct picks.
With your money?
Not going, yeah. So, but I'm basically like, head above water, like I'm even. Like, I rode a great Saturday, amazing Saturday, just withdrawal into a bad Sunday. So it, like, evens out.
Like Barkley says, if it's not a gambling problem, if you can afford it.
Well, I can't. This is why I'm not doing much with it.
Oh.
Chon, you said you doing good?
Yeah, I was riding pretty high. I hit a Burns parlay the other night, which I've been not doing good with the parlays. They've been very frustrating for me. There's been a few that I've had that I've hit every leg except the one that you really need. But I had Burns over points, over assists, over rebounds, and I need to stake the win. They did that. But on Sunday, it was a bad day. I think I went like 0-4 on Sunday. So, I mean, it's kind of been like you said, a roller coaster ride. But when you hit, it's a lot of fun. But when you don't, you're like, I should quit this.
From a entertainment standpoint, I enjoy it, and folks can get the DraftKings app right now. Coach Mac, put in $5, bet $5, and get 250 bonus bets in bonus bets instantly right there on DraftKings.
$250 in bonus bets?
Yes, sir.
Wow.
Yeah, and that's how you make a little money.
That's why I get all those bonuses. Text messages, Twitter messages, I guess.
Yeah, about people betting on Chattanooga women and winning big the other day.
I really should have charged for that information.
Give us a NASCAR update. What's going on?
You know, they went to COTA. I really wasn't all that fired up about COTA. Where do they go? They go to Richmond this week, I think. I'll be at Martinsville in two weeks on the 7th. I'll be at Martinsville with some with Meador and crew. So I'm looking forward to that. I've gotten off to a slow start interest wise. My guy retired, Harvick retired, and these Sunday games. I've had a lot of Sunday games, so I haven't been able to be emotionally involved in it. So I am looking forward to buckling down starting this week.
Steve Hill has a movie review. He says, "Happy Tuesday." HTMFs, HT to you, Steve. New Ghostbusters, 3.5 out of 5.
Interesting that he went with the 5 scale.
Why is that so interesting to everyone? I like a 5 scale.
I'm
JC like got on my case about that.
If you went to a 0.5, why not just go to a 10 so it's a straight number? So it's 7 out of 10.
Okay, you can do that in your own head.
I'm just saying, well, if you're going to do 0.5, you're making it hard on yourself.
Hard on who? Who's having a hard time with this?
In high school, we had this rule in my class. If you're going to do a scale, you can't do point anything. You just increase the scale to accustom for it. So if you have a 3.25 out of 5, you have to go to... Oh, God, math.
You set yourself up for this.
Math. 13 out of 20?
No. I love how he said, what'd you do? It? Oh, God.
6.5, yeah, 13.
You would multiply it by 4. Yeah. Whatever 4 times 3.25 is, an out of 20.
See, you made this way more complicated.
That's the
worst. Way more complicated.
If you start doing decimals, then you have this crazy world.
There you go.
So you enjoyed it somewhat.
Coach Mac, thanks for coming.
Thank y'all. This is a disjointed kind of hour. We could have done a long time.
I know.
Coach, we enjoy having you.
I love the... No, I was going to say sincerity, but I'm not going to.
No, I'm serious. We do enjoy having you, yeah. Especially Jamie. This is his favorite day of the week.
Jamie's the guy. He hasn't blocked me or dropped me or anything.
Coach, enjoy the Sweet 16.
And he has a unique spelling, too.
That he does. Enjoy the Sweet 16.
Yep, y'all too.
And, you can sit there and say, I was there. You can sit there on Thursday and say, I've been there.
I have, yeah.
Been there, done that. Let's take a break. Fun. We'll come back hour two. The Mully Man will join us. We'll talk some Pirate baseball. What does Mully want to see improved upon this week from the weekend where the Pirates lost 2 out of 3 to UTSA? We'll talk about that and more when we return Pirate Radio Live here on a Ticket Tuesday. We're giving you tickets to ECU and UAB baseball this weekend. We'll do that later on in today's show. Got a Pro Day recap as well. A lot more to go on Pirate Radio Live. Back with you after this. Thinking I'm believing every word. Call me beautiful, so original. Telling me I'm not like other girls. I was in my zone before you came along. Now I'm thinking. Hey, Pirate Nation. This is proud ECU graduate and former baseball player Brandon Manning inviting you to join my team at Farm Bureau Insurance. Right now is a good time to review your coverage with a local trusted agent like me. I will make myself available before or after business hours, and my clients always have my cell phone number if they need anything. From home, auto, or life, give me a call today and let's talk about your insurance coverage and about the Pirates. Call 531-1812 and go Pirates!
Turkey, ham, bacon, these and other meats are great around the holidays and every other day, but they all leave behind grease when you cook them, and grease is a real pain in the drain. When you pour grease down a drain, it cools and can clog sewer lines. That can lead to sewer spills, which are messy, bad for the environment, and can also be expensive. Never pour grease down the drain. Instead, collect it in a container like a used soup can or jar. Let it cool and throw it away in the trash. Together, we can protect our sewer system and the environment. For more information, go to GUC.com.
Home runs and high fives always go better with a Bud Light. Bud Light is America's favorite light beer and the official beer of the ECU Pirates. Whether you're headed to the ballpark, the jungle, or the couch, be sure to pick up and order some Bud Light and enjoy the ball game. Bud Light is always easy to drink and easy to enjoy. And remember, Pirate Nation, stay in the game and please drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Go Pirates!
It's bow time. Chicken or biscuits? That's an impossible choice. How can you decide between Bojangles' perfectly crispy, boldly seasoned chicken or their fluffy, made-from-scratch buttermilk biscuits? Well, the good news is you don't have to. With a Cajun chicken filet biscuit, you get the best of both worlds. An all-white meat chicken breast marinated with a bold blend of seasonings and served up on a fluffy, golden buttermilk biscuit. When it comes to real-deal Southern flavor, there's no reason you can't have it all. Order a Cajun chicken filet biscuit today. It's bow time.
Saturday, April 13th, the 4th Annual NC Strut Masters Championship is back. Presented by Whitetail Properties Real Estate. Turkey hunters from all over the country are headed east to put their skills to the test, and the top-scoring birds will win big cash prizes up to $30,000. Live performances by Sadie Bass, Nate Hosey, Styles Hurry, and much, much more. Registration is now open for two-man teams at ncstrutmasters.com. The new weigh-in will be held at Briley's Farm on Old Pactolus Highway in Greenville. Brought to you by Sam Jones Barbecue, Grady White Boats, Greenville Marine Outdoor, Big Rock Power Sports, Avian X Decoys, Metabo Tools, Country March Stores, Mountain Dew, Robinson Law Firm, and Old North State Trust. It's the NC Strut Masters Championship. We'll see you there!
Do you ever talk to yourself about where to eat today, and then you hear
Warren's Hot Dogs?
Then you're thinking, yeah, two hot dogs, chips and a drink for only $6.25 would be awesome.
Warren's Hot Dogs.
And maybe some homemade lemonade, perhaps a pizza or a sub, and definitely an apple or peach turnover.
Warren's Hot Dogs.
Don't overthink where to eat today. Go to Warren's Hot Dogs in Greenville across from Ron Ayers or in Chakawinity next to the fire station. Warren's Hot Dogs, serving the Pirate Nation since 1991. Go Pirate.
Bostick Sugg Furniture is proud to be the Greenville area's exclusive retailer of Lux Living and Bob Timberlake American Home. Elevate your home with beautiful Lux Living custom order sofas, chairs, and sectionals. Experience the elegant designs of Bob Timberlake's solid cherry furniture from the only dealer in North Carolina. Take an extra 10% off or get up to 48 months special financing. Lux Living, Bob Timberlake American Home, exclusively at Bostick Sugg Furniture.
This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250, and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930, and 104.1 FM Washington.
And I know she'll be the death of me, at least we'll bump in her. And she'll always get the best of me, the worst is yet to come.
You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? Keep it local. Print it local with University Sportswear. Contact them today at universitysportswearenc.com. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Have you heard? Greenville Auto World is under new ownership and is now part of the DriveHereNow.com network. DriveHereNow.com is run by local people who buy, service, detail, and sell everything directly to you. Greenville Auto World is now the fifth dealership to join DriveHereNow.com. Get car shopping today at DriveHereNow.com and choose a location near you. DriveHereNow.com, serving Eastern North Carolina for over 47 years and a proud supporter of the Pirates. Now let's head back in to PRL. Here's Clip.
Back with you, Pirate Radio Live. Shirley, can you see if Mully Man is ready for us? We got a Johnny Stat Stat.
Oh, baby.
To consider.
Stats to consider.
Johnny Stats in the house.
I do not vet these stats. I just read them as is because Johnny will never let us down on a stat. I trust Johnny more than I trust anyone when it comes to stats. How about this one? According to Johnny Stats, the Pirates are the only team in the nation that has not lost a game by more than two runs. Their six losses are by a combined eight runs. What a stat. We have Mike Mullis joining us on the Pirate Radio Live line. Mully, did you catch that stat from Johnny Stats? Johnny Robertson said The Pirates are the only team in the nation that has not lost a game by more than two runs to this point. Six losses by a combined eight runs. Your thoughts?
Yeah. I don't know. What are the thoughts on that? That would be would you really get blown out, or would you rather, you know, rather lose close? I don't know. But, yeah, kind of. That's just – and listen, if you watched anybody that watched UTSA series saw, you know, two or three things handled a different way, and those are – you know, the outcome's very different. So, yeah, kind of the tell of the season, though, you know, been right around it, but had, you know, had trouble, especially this past weekend, putting the road runners away.
Mully, watched some of the game with you on Saturday. East Carolina had a big lead and watched it evaporate, but ended up picking up the win, and that would be their only win of the series. So as you followed the baseball in San Antonio this weekend, Mully, what were those one or two things that went wrong for East Carolina that led to a losing series?
Well, quite frankly, one or two may be generous. I know that they were a little disappointed, maybe is maybe even light in saying that the playing surface was not kind to them. And of course, you know, coaches will tell you both teams have to play on that surface. But you know, I think there are a number of plays, and maybe the one that you kind of account to the surface was the Colby Wallace error on Sunday. But a lot of balls misplayed, even in the outfield where there are no necessarily bad hops on fly balls, and you know, you had some pass balls behind the plate. And I mean, it's just, again, man, and I think we've talked about it before. It's the maturity of a club that on the roster has age and experience, and it's one of those things where you wouldn't feel like that was a process that would be underway at this point in their careers. But I think that's what we're seeing, and guys adjusting to maybe a little brighter spotlight. And when I say that, I'm thinking of Jacob Starling in particular. You know, he's a guy that's kind of got to get it going for the Pirates to be able to do what they want to do. And so hopefully he'll have a big night tonight against Wilmington to kind of spark that fire. And, I don't know what else Cunningham could do. And, you know, the tough part is when you're offensively not supporting your best guy, in other words, you're not producing around him, it makes it pretty easy for other teams to deal with him. They just kind of circle him on the lineup, say, don't let him beat us. But, you know, JC, you've seen him be good at times, and we've kind of become accustomed to JC. We're going to kind of little mini funks. Luckily, they aren't long, but they can last a game. And every game you give away at this level, you know, is hard to get back. So, I think in a word, maturation is kind of what we need to see out of this club. These guys get off the bus a lot of places and should kind of be in the mentality of having the edge or the mental lead. You know, as they approach the game, and it looks like right now they're kind of having to play their way into a rhythm. And sometimes by the time you find that rhythm, you know, you're late in the game or the game is over. And obviously the bullpen challenges are real. And, you know, they've worked hard. They've had some really good signs of life with Norby. And Schenkman's been good at times. And, you know, you just really hope Eric Ritchie can continue to come around. So, again, we'll as Coach Godwin has said, let's see where this thing's at. You know, at the end of as he describes it, this marathon, and you know, that's when it's all important.
Mully, you can answer this generally or specifically, but what do you do with a guy like Starling and your playing and coaching experience? And everybody's different. Guys learn, you know, from different ways, different, I guess, punishments, if you want to call them that. But with a guy like Starling, do you move him down the lineup? Do you give him a day off? What are you saying to him? You know, just, again, in your experience, you can answer it generally what you would do, or if you know, you know, Jacob well enough, what the coaches need to do with him right now in his situation.
No, you know, and I'm not in the dugout with him and obviously the locker room, and so I don't know where he's at mentally, but I will say, I'll give you an example. If you remember a few years back, Bryce Orrell started out kind of very, you know, very similarly where, you know, 22, 24 games in, he was kind of non-existent, and you know, the staff stuck with him and gave him a chance to play his way through it because he had earned that right as an older guy, as a guy who had done everything that it took to get prepared and just wasn't having the on-the-field game-type success. And quite frankly, you know, you've got Crispin is your kind of your other option there, and, you know, with Barini's wrist issues I mean, I don't know that there's a whole lot of movement for, options for the staff. But moreover, I think you trust your upperclassmen and expect that he's going to find a way to kind of play his way through this. And, you know, historically, if you look back at his numbers, again, as the temperature rises, so does his batting average. So I think, you know, he gets into this part of the season and kind of going forward, you got to hope to see that spark. And right now, you know, I don't think you press the panic button necessarily. I do think you're very aware of it. But I think they're going to continue to be patient and give him every chance to play himself out of this little funk.
Mike Mullis joining us, Pirate Radio Live Line. Mully, you got the call tonight?
Yeah, here now, kind of watching BP and kind of doing some homework, getting ready to roll. Should be a fun one, good weather. We better get out tonight and enjoy the good weather because it looks like it may be a couple days.
Yeah, how about pitching wise for these Pirates? Saw Treya Savage have, I guess, his worst outing of the year so far, and we all believe he will bounce back, probably with a great performance coming up on Thursday, and gets that one day shorter. He's probably ready to go back out there, Mully, mentally and hopefully physically, but certainly after getting dinged for four runs the other day, he's ready to get back out there. How about Root Hunter? Do you think the Pirates stick with Hunter in that Sunday role? It'll be Saturday this week, but anything changing with the pitching, in your opinion?
I don't think so. Again, I think that they're kind of settled into that. And you know, to hear Coach Godwin talk, he's not dissatisfied with where Hunter is. I think Hunter's making some mental adjustments, and that sounds kind of, you know, rainbows and unicorns. But the reality is, the stuff is there, the ability is there. It's kind of meshing the two together. So I think they continue to roll with the way it is. As it relates to your Savage. You know, there's lots of pitchers in the country that would love to go out and have that stat line that he had on Friday night. He gave up four runs, but he only gave up four runs. You know, and that's one of those deals where, you know, in college baseball with the level of hitters and, you know, metal bats and all that is, you know, four runs is not typically something you can't overcome. So Yeah, do I expect him? I think the thing that probably catches all of us is we're so used to him having double-digit strikeouts, and he only had, I think he had like five punchies. So you start looking at that going, okay, he didn't have his best stuff. And I think that's part of that maturation process, Clip, where that game and in that environment, it's got to be 100% internal motivation because there's not, you know, a Carolina sitting in the other dugout. You're not pitching at Clark LeClaire Stadium in front of, you know, 4,000 of your best friends. So, I mean, it's a little bit different deal where, you know, you've got to find it from within and learning experience for all parties involved. And you're right, I fully expect that we'll see Trey bounce back and Root follow suit. And you know, the wild card factor in that rotation is Jake Hunter. And all we can hope for is that Jake starts to get deeper into outings. And, you know, typically by the time we're getting to Sunday, man, we've already seen a lot of guys in the pen. So, you know, his outings on Sunday, being able, like I said, to get a bit deeper, will certainly help that pen to perform better on Sundays.
Mully, we've seen UNCW in a meeting already this year. When you look at them, what's something that stands out maybe that Pirate fans should worry about, or something that you think ECU can exploit tonight? What do you see with the Seahawks coming in here?
Well, first and foremost, as we know, you know, the Seahawks, the Camels, you know, these midweek games are big, and both of those teams I just mentioned have kind of been a burr in the saddle for the Pirates, you know, historically back to the CAA days. So I expected the same scrappy nature of play. They are, from what we're hearing, with the starting arms of a guy who hasn't thrown a whole lot, we don't know a whole lot about him, but they're coming off a hard-fought series with Elon. So, you know, they're probably a little bit taxed as well, and these midweek games can obviously always get interesting. From what I understand, I expect to see Kaler go tonight for the Pirates. So, you know, if he's on and working fast and doing what he likes to do, we could see a game that moves right along and you know, maybe controls the scoring from the Wilmington side. If he doesn't have his best stuff, it might be a toe-to-toe, nose-to-nose kind of knockdown drag-out. And, you know, those last three outs in the bottom of the ninth could be critical. If we see that, I think we're looking at something that resembles a little bit of a football score. Again, these teams are both coming off big weekends, and they're going to play each other hard. We know that.
Mike Mullis joining us. Shirley, what place is Mully in our bracket challenge? Or is Mully in the challenge?
No,
Mully didn't fill out a bracket. Dang.
No, didn't get down there. A lot going on.
Fair enough.
Baseball.
You enjoy the tournament so far? Any thoughts on it?
I have. I mean, can anybody beat Purdue?
Can anybody beat UConn?
Can anybody beat UConn? One of those two. Somebody's got to beat somebody. Gonzaga's really got me. And it's like with Gonzaga every year, man, they just win postseason games, right? It's like, we could skip the regular season, let's go to the postseason, and we'll just beat up on whoever we play. And there were some maybe, you know, and everybody kind of reaches for the Cinderella, and I guess, you know, Oakland and I guess NC State has kind of, you know, moved into that role for a lot of the country, at least around here. And I think, man, these teams, gosh, it's kind of weird to say, you know, think of Purdue as a blue blood, but the bigger programs, I think, are who you're going to see standing there at the end.
And it's been a little different from last year in that regard, where you've got all eight of the top one and two seeds from each region in the Sweet 16 and trying to advance to the Elite Eight. So those lack of upsets, Mully, do make for some great matchups this upcoming weekend. So I'll take it.
Yeah, no, and look, Houston's going to be there are some really there should be some really good games coming forward with, you know, with the better teams, but the higher ranked teams. And I will tell you, man, it is so much fun. Like that first weekend, and you know, I mean, I enjoy college basketball, especially this time of the year, because I'm just a fan of the competition and sports in general. But man, it's a lot of fun. And then, you know, got Major League opening day and college baseball, minor leagues opened, and you know, fun time of the year.
Opening day coming up on Thursday here in the States anyway. O's and Angels. We got Braves and Phillies. Mully, I don't know, any surprise? Who's the Rangers of this year? If you knew, you could make a lot of money on it, but who's that team? Like, is it the Reds? Could it be the Orioles breaking through? Who's your surprise breakthrough team this year?
Well, and that, I was just going to say, the Orioles still a surprise.
Nah.
I mean, they are freaking good. And, I mean, they've got three guys in the minor leagues that deserve to be on big league rosters that I can think of right off the top of my head. So, you know, I like the O's. I mean, I really do. I will tell you, man, I enjoyed that series in Korea. It took me back to the KBO during COVID days. So, you know, wake up in the morning, cut the TV on, and you got a pretty good game. And, you know, you had a more traditional game, and then you had a game that was, you know, both teams scored double digits and a lot of fun to watch. Now I think, you know, the thing that's overshadowing opening day right now is probably Shohei Ohtani and whether or not how that's all going to be, adjudicated, or how that thing's going to play out in the, you know, in the court of public opinion, as well as, you know, he's just got to say all the right things, or rather his interpreter's got to say the right things. It sure seems to be, you know, where there's smoke, there's fire, and I know that guy's got a ton of money in the bank, but I would think most people and most, you know, most businesses and I don't know that I know anybody that has that kind of liquid cash, but, you know, I think most people would recognize $4.5 million coming out of their account, but, you know, maybe I'm wrong. That's certainly a problem I've never dealt with.
Yeah, unfortunately.
But, you know, I do wonder how that's all going to shake out. And you know, and of course, it's given Pete Rose one last platform to say, "Hey, look at me! Don't forget about me over here." And you just got to feel like Major League Baseball is not going to let their most precious commodity become tarnished if they can prevent it in any way.
Mully, good stuff. Thanks for joining us. Have a great call tonight on ESPN Plus, and we'll talk to you again next week, man.
Awesome, buddy. Talk to you soon.
The Mully Man joining us live from Clark LeClaire Stadium, getting ready for some baseball tonight.
John. Yes, sir. On a Tuesday. Check Tuesday.
We also have softball action going on.
I don't know this reference. What is that?
Sorry, brother.
Come on, brother.
What are y'all doing?
Check Tuesday.
What are y'all doing? Shirley, what are they doing?
I have no idea.
No, are y'all going to explain it?
No, is this kind of like right side, strong side mess that
yesterday? No. That is a reference to something that I'm aware of. What is this a reference to?
Check Tuesday.
All right, anyway, go ahead, Shirley.
ECU, Elon at Max R. Joyner Stadium. No score as of yet in the top of the second inning.
Pirates trying to get a little mo here, coming off a series win over ranked Charlotte.
Yeah.
Good to see her.
Give me that wink.
All she's got to do is just to give me that wink. Chad doesn't get it.
Come on, brother.
Grimes on Bigfoot said it's too bad that Pete Rose didn't have an interpreter. Crushed it. Mike P said Mully is the first person who I've heard say, quote, "I enjoyed it. Took me back to the COVID days," end quote. Yeah, that's true. He enjoyed the KBO part of the COVID days, not the actual COVID part.
Probably one of the best trophies in sports.
Chad says, no matter how many times Chandler does that, I still don't get it.
It's a guy on TikTok. It's,
he's a Twitch streamer.
Twitch streamer named Sketch. And I was told to do it.
He's a cool cat, man.
Who told you to do it?
Oh, Joey.
Joey said, check Tuesday.
Check Tuesday. Yeah, check Joey. Tuesday.
Dude.
That's fine.
Damn, we
can pull some great clips from him.
Oh, you know who does a good sketch?
Rebecca.
Oh, McChrystal does a great one, too. McChrystal's done it on the bench before at games. Oh, my Lord.
He did
hilarious.
It in Wilmington.
In Wilmington, yeah. He did it all day long.
Good job, brother.
He said, we need three runs here like a Snickers bar. I'm not satisfied.
Good stuff. I'll show you a couple of
No, thanks.
No, it's funny. Come on.
Thanks, brother.
You kids do your kids stuff.
Tuesday.
I'll do my adult stuff.
He played a game of Madden with Vontaze Perfect.
Here's one that you'll get a reference to clip.
All right.
I showed a video clip from Beavis and Butthead in Cornholio, and where Cornholio is taken to the police station, and I guess he was entertained, but I found it hysterically funny.
You showed this to who?
I showed this to Zach and to Chandler.
To young Zach.
Neither one of them knew who Cornholio was.
I have not watched Beavis and Butthead.
Yeah, so. That's fair. Joey says I don't text him back. I wonder what he texted me.
Joey always texts me back.
He said, yo, you got any fantasy baseball I can get involved in? I'm going to be honest with you. I'm trying to be in some fantasy baseball. I do not, Joey. I'm sorry.
I have a league. We closed.
What's wrong with Joey? Why wouldn't you let him in?
It's an invite-only exclusive club.
We actually did our draft at Trivia last week. We did the draft there. So if Joey came out, we probably could have slipped him in.
I'm sorry, Joey. You are being left out. No, I'm not in any fantasy baseball leagues this year.
I don't even understand fantasy baseball, so we'll see how this goes.
But
I don't do fantasy. I used to do fantasy football, but I quit.
I'm going to be honest with you. You could do some daily stuff. I guess.
Yeah.
We have to go that route.
Go the Big Daddy route.
Let's take a break. When we return, more to go. We'll recap some of Pro Day. We'll bang out an interview from there. I want to save some for Bryce as well. Also want to talk about the kickoff rule with Bryce. Remind me of that for hour three. More to go. Pirate Radio Live here on a Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Oh, my God. Back with you after this.
Yeah. Girl, I know. She told me to worry about it. She told me to worry no more.
Hey, everybody. This is Aaron Williams, and it's March. And here at New Blue Service Group, we are starting to think about Easter and what a blessing it was that Jesus Christ rose from the dead on the third day. Speaking of rising, we would love to bless a family during this season with rising the temperature of the water in their home. If you or anyone you know is in need of a new water heater, we have teamed up with Hughes Plumbing Supply in Winterville to donate a water heater to someone in need. No cost out of your pocket. Contact me directly at 252-717-6888. God bless and go Pirates.
Home runs and high fives always go better with a Bud Light. Bud Light is America's favorite light beer and the official beer of the ECU Pirates. Whether you're headed to the ballpark, the jungle, or the couch, be sure to pick up and order some Bud Light and enjoy the ball game. Bud Light is always easy to drink and easy to enjoy. And remember, Pirate Nation, stay in the game and please drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Go Pirates!
Hey Pirate Nation, be sure to have the best and comfortable shoes with a stop at Fleet Feet. This is ECU alum Chris Lunyon, owner of Fleet Feet of Greenville, and we provide solutions through one-on-one service to runners, walkers, and everyone in between. Fleet Feet has the tools and technology to get you in the right shoe, including a 3D foot scanner that measures arch height, width, and more. Come visit us at 207 East Arlington Boulevard in the old Gordon's Golf location. Fleet Feet, we run for you.
The brunch is back. The famous brunch buffet at Fifth Street Hardware has a variety of breakfast and lunch items from 10:30 to 2, including an omelet station and prime rib, and a special Sunday cocktail menu, including mimosa flights. Don't forget, Fifth Street Hardware has lunch specials every day, along with over 40 beers on tap. Trivia Wednesday, live music every Thursday night, and a late night menu through the weekend. Visit FifthStreetHardware.com or give them a follow on Facebook and Instagram for a weekly lineup and more. Go Pirates! UBE and PirateWear.com are proud to offer the Pirate Nation its largest inventory of ECU merchandise and tailgate supplies ever. UBE has the best prices in town, so that makes UBE your one-stop shop for all things ECU. UBE does daily restocks of Champion, Adidas, and Under Armour. Don't forget to bring your young Pirates to plunder the Crow's Nest, which is the only kids' store dedicated to ECU. Plenty of free parking in Uptown Greenville. Visit them online at PirateWear.com. Go Pirates!
I'm back, and so glad to be back in the town that I love, but also glad to be back with the best chiropractor anywhere. Worth Chiropractic was my choice before I left Greenville, and my travels have not changed my mind. No one offers the care or service like Worth Chiropractic. Neck pain, back pain, and of course, sports-related injuries, they will get you back to being you, naturally and safely. Worth Chiropractic, two convenient locations on Arlington Boulevard. Free consultations, and they'll work with your lawyer and file your insurance. Call 1-800-BACK-DOC today.
This is Brian Harris with 360 Golf Carts, Pitt County's go-to shop for all things golf carts. We have easy-go, club car, and utility carts to choose from. Whether it's for the beach, riding around the neighborhood, or working in the yard, 360 Golf Carts has the perfect ride for you. If you have issues with your current cart, take it by my shop for an expert's diagnosis. From parts to sales to service, we have you covered. We will even deliver right to you. So come see me, Brian Harris, on Highway 43, just past D.H. Conley High School. 360 Golf Carts, Pirates supporting Pirates.
Do you ever talk to yourself about where to eat today, and then you hear,
Warren's Hot Dogs.
Then you're thinking, yeah, two hot dogs, chips and a drink for only $6.25 would be awesome.
Warren's Hot Dogs.
And maybe some homemade lemonade, perhaps a pizza or a sub, and definitely an apple or peach turnover.
Warren's Hot Dogs.
Don't overthink where to eat today. Go to Warren's Hot Dogs in Greenville across from Ron Ayers or in Chakawinity next to the fire station. Warren's Hot Dogs, serving the Pirate Nation since 1991. Go Pirates.
Pirate Radio.
ECU
Pirates.
Can't nobody do
what we do.
You know.
That's right.
All right then.
Yeah!
The voice of the Pirate Nation. You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? Keep it local. Print it local with University Sportswear. Contact them today at universitysportswearenc.com. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? Keep it local and print it local with University Sportswear. Contact them today at universitysportswearenc.com, the official sportswear provider of Pirate Radio. And Bud Light reminds Pirate fans to always stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Now let's head back into PRL. Here's Clip.
Back with you, Pirate Radio Live. Portal news. Quentin DeBunge entering the transfer portal.
So Dabunje and Baela came from Tennessee.
Yes.
Zach says yes. Chandler looks confused.
Well, I know Dabunje is, but
well, yeah, Baela, I don't know.
No, Baela, I don't think
came. Baela was not at Tennessee. Okay.
I got that fact checked.
Somebody fact check me on that one.
Ben Baela.
So right now we are at 4 transfers. Baela, Dabunje, LeCount, Brandon Johnson.
I look up Ben Baela on the ECUPirates.com. It says, it looks like you're lost.
He came from a JUCO in Texas.
Yeah, not a Tennessee.
You get an error 404 if you go to ECU's website.
That's why I looked at you weird. Because I knew Quentin Dabunje went to Tennessee. I had a feeling Ben Baela did not.
So no Tennessee ties.
No. Nah. But he is French like Dabunje. From Le Chesnay.
Or two Frenchmen.
Le Rochesnay. No, Le Chesnay.
Yeah. Looking at 24/7 Sports, LaDonte Felton, brother of RJ, has signed his letter of intent. And then we have one hard commit.
Hard commit.
Jay Shane Woodard.
JUCO.
So, and that's it for the incoming class?
That's it?
As of now. That'll change very rapidly.
But I'm wondering how many newcomers on next year's team will be via the portal versus via JUCO and freshmen.
We only got 2 transfers last year.
Pettiford and
Cam Hayes.
Cam Hayes. Do you count Vungo?
Vungo's out of high school.
Okay.
Southpaw just scored.
I was wondering why Shirley was holding up a fist.
Dub Bug scoreboard update.
All right.
2-0 East Carolina.
2-0 Pirates. Let's keep up the good work there. Yeah, so so what do we have on this basketball roster right now? We've got Bobby Pettiford.
RJ Felton.
And RJ Felton.
Cam Hayes.
Colin Richard.
Let's do a starting lineup of who's there right now.
Malonga at 5.
Ezra Assar.
Okay.
That's the 4 and the 5.
And then we just named the other ones probably. Although you're going to be small.
Bobby at 1.
Yeah.
Cam at 2.
RJ at 3.
That's tiny.
Ezra 4, Sear 5.
That is tiny.
Sear's we don't big, know what but... Cam's going to do though, right?
Because nah, he's not going to grow.
Well, he did participate in Senior Day.
Well, I mean, you know what? We need to. We don't know how much these guys will grow. This all.
Well, we know he's not going to grow.
RJ could be 6'8".
That would be one awesome. Could you imagine
a 6'8" RJ?
Dude,
to tell him hit 7 foot, he's so close.
He could. Will these guys? Do you like Callum or do you like Callum?
Like, he's a personal friend.
Is it a bit? Okay. So.
It was his birthday yesterday. There you go.
That's great.
Happy birthday, Callum.
There you go.
Yep. What'd you get him?
Nothing.
All right.
He was still at home.
So you're not that close. Or you're exchanging.
You know his whereabouts, gifts. Too? That's crazy.
We went to school together.
Do you think he could be worth discussing during his ECU career?
Not as a starter. But as a bench player, I think.
Develop into something.
Yeah. Malonga's going to be the center. I don't think Callum will take that.
Yeah. You just got to hope he can get stronger, get more comfortable, and be a force on the inside.
At the end of the year, it seemed like he was finding that. So.
Yeah. I agree. Pirate Hoops.
I have seen us mention.
Question mark.
There was a transfer page on Twitter that talks about who's talked to these players once they hit the portal. A white guy from Penn. We apparently talked to him. So we're about to get our accountant, baby.
Oh.
And he's Ivy League smart.
Has he hit 10 threes in a game?
He averaged 17 a game at Penn. So I imagine he's hit a few threes, but not 10.
Do we even look at numbers anymore for guys that are coming in here after we saw Caleb Account's numbers?
Well, this is a college number versus a LA high school number.
I'm just saying. He averaged, 30 in
33.
High school?
33.
Yeah. And how?
It's LA County. That's a big basketball area, I thought.
I would, too. I would love to see this league now.
Were they all the same height as him?
He must have been a 1A school. He went to some, tiny Christian school or something.
I mean, but 33 is 33.
Yeah,
just never translated here, unfortunately. All right, Jamie's got a weird question.
Nope.
I'm uncomfortable even bringing it up.
Oh, Lord.
So I'm watching my 15-year-old daughter. This is Jamie talking.
Okay.
Because I, too, have a 15-year-old daughter.
Ah.
showing some small PDA affection in our driveway right now to her boyfriend.
Okay. What are we doing here, bro?
He's a dad. I mean,
do you think that's an okay age for me to see that right now? Why are you asking us?
One, I'm 25 and have no children.
Does it depend on the level of PDA?
Does she know? So are you watching out the window?
Yeah. Like, are you being like, are you just like staring out the window? And what are they like? Are they hugging? Are they, what are they doing?
Making out. I mean,
they like, said, I don't like it. Yeah. I wouldn't like it either.
No, just stop watching.
Yeah. turn back to your computer or something. I mean, your question was, do you think that's an okay age for me to see that right now?
What age is it okay? Is there an age?
Yeah, I mean, are you going to be more comfortable with it 10 years from now when she's making out with a dude?
It's like, still your daughter.
I don't want to see it ever.
Is it okay if I see it? I don't know. If I have a daughter, later in my life, I don't want to see it. Period.
He said, "I'm not trying to flip out, just a kiss and some hugs. I don't like hearing about this."
All right, Jamie, you're done.
This is off the rails, brother. Hey, brother, this is off the rails, brother.
Jamie, you're cut off.
I would beat on the window or something, or be like, "I'm in here. Yep. I'm in here."
Yeah, yell at him real quick.
Yeah.
Y'all can stop now.
Cough really loud.
You're 15. That's not a good age for me to see this.
Do you have an air horn? Blow an air horn.
Yeah, you're talking.
Do something. You got to get out of this situation, though, quickly. Would you like for me to call her? What's her phone number? I'll tell her to stop. Call her live on the air.
Cliff just asked for 15-year-old's phone number.
Someone's calling me. Hello?
I'm parenting, though. Okay, Jamie said. I'm going out there. Jamie, can you do a live stream of this?
Yes, please.
Can we connect him to this? Call in the show real quick. We'll phone him in.
Chad said, this show is taking a strange turn, asking creepy old guys about your 15-year-old daughter. Unfortunately, I'm the only creepy old guy here.
How am I a creepy old guy?
Chandler's not old enough, and Zach is like 4 years older than this girl.
So is 20 a good age for him?
Not a good age.
I've only ever hugged a girl in front of my parents.
Yeah, it's just awkward. Why?
A hug's fine.
I think the girl thinks that Jamie's not watching the dog.
Yeah, she definitely doesn't know.
I don't, unless she just hates you.
Is this like a hanging out at the car type of deal?
Yeah.
This is like a, I think it's like, it feels like a drop off. He's dropping her off from whatever they were doing.
She obviously doesn't have her license, so maybe he does.
So it's an older guy.
How old is this dude? Is he like 27? That's going to change everything.
That's going to change a lot, and you need to call the police. I mean,
call the law.
I mean, his age could vary from 16 to 80, and we don't know that.
Eric said when Sean has his first child, he's going to teach her arithmetic using NCAA money lines. That is, I mean, teach a good way to learn math.
Yeah. In high school, we learned how to count cards in my statistics class.
Chad said, you can do what my dad did when I was making out with my girlfriend in middle school. Clap really loud one time.
One time now.
Was he clapping for you? Like, way to go, son.
No, just once. Just one big clap, yeah.
Having a son and a daughter is different, too. Jamie said it's a drop-off.
It is a drop-off. I read the situation.
Chad Moore said, Closet K is an old soul.
You are Closet K.
And I am an old soul.
Eric said, what do you get when you divide a Hornets money line by a Panthers plus the points? It's a good way to...
Plus 1 million.
I knew my... I don't know if I knew football because of multiplication or multiplication because of football. I think it was, I knew my 7 multiplication table because of touchdowns.
That could be a really good way of teaching it to kids who are interested.
So when you're watching football,
you just assume they're going
to
miss.
And a team scores a touchdown.
That's 6 points.
That's how you go by touchdowns? Sixes? Mm-hmm. Okay, fair enough. I'll remember that. Moving on.
A touchdown is 6 points.
Yeah, I'm aware of that. And in the game of football, when a team scores a touchdown, you assume that possession's going to end with 6 points.
No.
What do you assume it's going to end with?
7.
All right, so what are you arguing here?
But a touchdown is 6 points.
No, you just proved that you count by 7, though.
The 7.
We know that, dude. But watching football games, on the weekends, you see the scores go by sevens, not sixes.
Unless they miss the extra point.
Or no crap!
Unless they go for two and don't get it.
How often does that happen?
It happens quite a bit.
No, it doesn't. What's the percentage?
About 22.6?
No, it's not. You're
maybe,
a fool.
Maybe for ECU football.
I don't know what you're trying to do, what point you're trying to make. It's not going to work.
I'm stating a fact. I'm saying that touchdowns are 6 points.
When you watch a football game,
And I'm like, oh, touchdown. All right, let's see if they get this extra point. See if they can get the seven here.
Chandler, your child is going to be dumb. I hate to talk about your child that is not born yet.
Don't say that, man.
I know. I'm sorry. That was really mean.
That was very mean.
But your child is going to be a moron.
He just got a chuckle out of Glenn over there.
That is not nice to say.
It is. It's a terrible thing to say. I'm going to need to have a talk with your wife before y'all procreate. Just say, look, you know what's going to happen here, right? Do you understand what these next 18 to 24 years are going to be like?
Oh, God, we have a big dog running.
Oh, big dog.
Should I not have said that, big dog? Was that too much?
He's probably agreeing with you. Oh, man. Will my child be dumb?
It was the perfect amount of disrespect and the best thing that's been said on this program in a solid 5 years.
Your son's going to be a moron.
He called your genetics dumb. Like you are dumb genetically. Like your DNA stands for dumb.
Neurological.
Adolescent.
It's like you don't get my points or you...
I do, man. I'm just...
You just want to argue?
I just want to argue.
Okay.
I thought you would know that by now.
If they're Iowa fans, they can count by two really well.
Steve said intelligence skips a generation. Interesting.
Now we know why
Steve... So he is going to be smart.
Now we know why Steve is the way he is. He's tipped us off.
Big dog coming in. Guy, you sound like we do. Coming in. Like, just like...
It's that time of year.
Golly, man. Yeah, I've been awful.
Everybody's stuffed.
I try to stay from outside. I mean, in general.
That pollen has been
because it is. It's just a skeet fest out there.
Yeah.
What?
Huh? What fest?
And it's been wearing me down, definitely. Chad's asking what hat are you wearing?
This is a Columbus Clippers.
The Clippers,
I think.
Yeah. You got the ship on the front.
It's got a ship with them. It's pirate-ish.
AAA team for the Cleveland Guardians.
Clip, have you mentioned the hat that you got today?
I did get a hat today.
Did you?
Snap.
Yeah, I'll show it after the break.
Okay.
I need to figure out. I think I know who sent it to me. I only know one person that lives in Oregon.
Another mystery hat?
Yeah.
Oh.
But this one is... What team was it?
It's the Emerald City,
the Eugene Emerald?
Eugene Emerald.
Yeah. Oh, it's the Bigfoot. It's the Sasquatch one.
No.
No, it's not.
There's a whale on it, I believe.
Oh, it's the...
Exploding whales.
Yes.
Yeah.
There you go.
I got an exploding whale.
That's cool.
That's dope.
I want to say it's from a guy I went to high school with that lives out there, but I'm not positive on that. All right, let's take a break. Steve wants to have a degree off with you. He said, how many degrees you got?
Oh, wow.
I mean,
we got a measuring contest going on right now.
How many does Steve have? Is it over under at 1.5?
I guess it's over.
I guess he's over?
Yeah.
I'm under 1.5.
I'm under.
I'm okay with
I'm
that.
Under one.
I'm fine with my under 1.5 degree.
All right. A degree off.
Hey, I don't need that sheet of paper to make me feel good.
Right.
Exactly.
Amen. You know, I don't think as a person that you need that validation. I think your worth is internal.
No.
That was deep.
Wow.
Now let's all sing Greatest Love of All by Whitney Houston.
I'm just trying to make Steve feel bad.
We had to sing that in, which looking back, I think this was a good thing. We sang The Greatest Love of All in one of my classes.
We should, I mean, if you brought stuff like that back, I feel like it wouldn't get over, but it might.
It wouldn't get over, brother. Not today. Things have changed. We'll take a break, come back. More to go. Pirate Radio Live on a Tuesday after this.
Here with Jeff Stein at Brown & Wood, it's a great time to buy a used vehicle.
It's not a great time, it's a perfect time to buy a used car from Brown & Wood. We have over 115 used vehicles in stock, and we're number one in the market on price. We have limited lifetime powertrain on all of our used cars under 80,000 miles, so go to brownandwoodauto.com to find out more. Four brands, three generations, two rooftops, and one goal, to make sure you leave a happy customer.
Come experience Greenville's newest theater, Golden Ticket Cinemas, located on Greenville Boulevard near Cracker Barrel. With stadium seating and reserved luxury recliners, you can enjoy the movie along with great concessions such as L House sliders, delicious wings, pizza, and hot dogs. And they even have milkshakes. You can always find great deals at Golden Ticket Cinemas, such as $5.50 Ticket Tuesdays and free family movies at 11 a.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show in style with luxurious amenities and top-notch service at Golden Ticket Cinemas.
You've worked hard to make your business successful, and that's why it's really important to always have a bank that's in your corner when you need them. This is Chris Richards from First Bank, and our experienced team of local bankers includes Lee Watson, Ashley Capps, Josh Hooten, and Heath Nisbet. To get the business services that are right for your business, come and see one of our experienced team members at First Bank on Arlington Boulevard in Greenville. First Bank, together with our customers, we're creating a world where individuals and communities thrive. Member FDIC.
North Carolina State Parks invites you to enjoy camping your way. With the weather changing, booking your own cabin is the perfect solution for your camping getaway. Reserve campsites or cabins today at Jones Lake, Goose Creek, and Cliffs of the Neuse. Whether you enjoy traditional camping or air-conditioned cabins that can be rented with Wi-Fi, your next adventure can include hiking, beautiful scenery, and sunsets by the campfire. For information on booking a cabin, visit ncparks.gov.
The wait is over. DraftKings Sportsbook, an official sports betting partner of NASCAR, is now live in North Carolina. Now you can legally bet on all your favorite sports anytime, anywhere, right here in North Carolina with DraftKings. For a limited time, new customers who sign up with the promo code PIRATE and bet $5 will receive $250 instantly in bonus bets. DraftKings has the best features, including same-game parlays, player props, and more, with fast and easy payouts right at your fingertips. Get ready for the NCAA tournament with DraftKings. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app now using the code PIRATE and bet $5 to get $250 instantly in bonus bets. Only on DraftKings Sportsbook with the code PIRATE. The crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov. 21 plus, North Carolina only. Bonus bets expire 168 hours after issuance. Deposit and eligibility restrictions apply. Terms at DraftKings.com/sportsbook/NC. NASCAR is not a sponsor of this promotion and used under license.
Hi, I'm Walker Allen Voliva, and I'm with CopyPro. CopyPro has been locally owned and operated here in Eastern North Carolina for over 50 years. CopyPro is the leader in office technology. Does your business struggle with keeping printing costs low or producing professional documents? Here at CopyPro, total satisfaction is our number one priority. We have a variety of solutions to help reduce your printing expenses and make your business more productive. Call us today at 1-800-682-6558 or online at copypro.net. CopyPro, we are the professional office systems people.
We filled the trucks so you'll save big bucks during the Lazy Boy Truckload Sale at Bostic Sug Furniture. Look for the Lazy Boy truck in our parking lot. It's filled with Lazy Boy furniture at huge savings. Take advantage of big rig discounts of up to 50% off Lazy Boy recliners and motion sofas, Lazy Boy stationary furniture, leather, sectionals, and chairs. But quantities are limited. There's no reorders, no rain checks. So roll in before these savings roll out during the Lazy Boy Truckload Sale at Bostic Sug Furniture.
Pirate Radio is the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 2 of Pirate Radio Live. Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? Keep it local. Print it local with University Sportswear. Contact them today at universitysportswearenc.com. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. When you walk through the doors of Villa Verde, you'll experience the sights, sounds, and smells of authentic Dominican flavors. Villa Verde is inviting you to come by and try some of their amazing empanadas, famous red snapper, grouper bites, Cuban sandwiches, and more. You can relax on the patio with a fresh mojito or a cold beer while enjoying one of their out-of-this-world desserts like the rum pineapple cake. Villa Verde on 10th Street, a platform for good and a proud supporter of the Pirate Nation. And as we head back into the show, a quick Buccaneer Music Hall scoreboard update brought to you by Da Buck. It is the bottom of the 1-2-3rd inning, and East Carolina up 4-1 on Elon. Runners at first and second, and one Annie Kate Dalton in the box for the Pirates.
All right, we'll keep you up to date on that one as ECU softball coming off a great weekend. Winners of 2 out of 3 over ranked Charlotte. So congratulations to them, and hopefully we can get another W today. We're giving out some tickets coming up in hour number 3 as we'll have a pair of tickets to Thursday, Friday, and Saturday for ECU baseball as they take on UAB, courtesy of Ticket Tuesday, Toby Williams and Sailor Warehouse giving away these tickets, and we'll make you a winner coming up later on today's program. DraftKings Sportsbook is now live in North Carolina. You can legally bet on your favorite sports anytime, anywhere, right here in North Carolina with DraftKings. For a limited time, new customers who sign up with promo code PIRATE and bet $5 will receive $250 instantly in bonus bets. DraftKings has the best features, including same-game parlays, player props, and more, with fast and easy payouts right at your fingertips. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app now using the code PIRATE and bet $5 to get $250 instantly in bonus bets only on DraftKings Sportsbook with the code PIRATE. The crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov. 21 plus, North Carolina only. Terms at DraftKings.com/sportsbook/NC. All right, Big Dog, you are looking at the NBA slate tonight. I have nothing to add to it because I have not followed the NBA this year with the Hornets being so bad. So what are you looking at tonight?
So tonight I like early tip. You got the Warriors in the Heat. Now you might look at that game and say Warriors, high scoring, a lot of three-point shooting. That's not going to happen. The under in Miami Heat home games has hit 7 out of 8 times. So, and it's risen. It's earlier it was at 217.5. It's risen, it's up to 218. I like the under all day, every day in that matchup. A little bit of inside knowledge on that one.
All right.
Just from the breakdown of past Miami home games. A late arriving crowd. The teams really don't get into it in the first quarter. Then they kind of sleepwalk their way through it. Maybe got their idea in their minds on plans later. On South Beach.
Warriors only get one trip there?
Yeah, it's that type of night.
Okay.
Kind of like what happened to Boston last night in Atlanta. They were thinking about those Magic City Wings, and they fell apart late in that game, even though they were up by 30-plus at one point. A shocking turn of events. And then my second NBA hit of the night, late night, Mavericks-Kings, once again, you think, look at those teams, you think high scoring, you think good offense. With Luka and then Swiper and Domantas Sabonis, but that's not the case because they're both on a back-to-back tonight, and the under in Kings home games, because their defense is solid and their great rebounding team has hit 7 out of the last 10. So you want to hit the under there. It's at 232.5 right now, which I still feel is high, so I would take the under there.
Okay. All right. The Undertaker.
I've been trying to make it happen for a year, but it's here now, baby.
Now it's natural. The Undertaker has joined us, and he's taking unders.
I took the under last night and the 15.5 with West Virginia and Iowa in the women's tournament, and that was a cash. It was good stuff.
Eric says there are tremendous, terrific NHL Eastern Conference matchups tonight. I see that the Hurricanes will be taking on the Penguins tonight. Bruins and Panthers going on tonight. Flyers, Rangers. Does kind of feel like a playoff night when you see some of these Eastern Conference matchups. And then you've got, Wednesday, Bruins, Lightning. So Bruins on game one of a back-to-back as they take on the Panthers coming up tonight. Jamie says, what's Big Dog's current betting status? How has he done overall?
We were doing really well after the first weekend of the tournament. We were up quite a bit. And then a full slate of NBA happened, and it took away some of the profits.
Yeah.
Which is why it's called gambling, folks. Some nights you win, some nights you lose.
Yeah.
We did hit 16 in a row on Friday, which is amazing.
That's nuts.
That was an amazing feeling, my goodness. And that's, when you have that many games going on at one time, you can kind of live on in the live betting moment, and you can chase things, and then it chased and it hit. It was an amazing run. But once again, it's called gambling because the first day I didn't do too well. So, you know, it comes and goes. And I think that's the take-home message here, is that you treat it as a hobby and not as a way of paying the rent.
There you go. And the Undertaker is taking unders tonight in NBA action. All right. Good stuff, Big Dog. Appreciate you joining us.
Yeah, man. First time in a while.
We all sound just terrible.
We do.
On the air.
Yeah, my voice.
And you got to go out to the
pollen.
You got to go out to the jungle.
I do. Most of the pollen is.
And we got two interns down today.
Yeah, with
Delaney and Alex
with the flu,
having flu games.
Yeah.
Well, not flu even gate. Flu games. They're out.
I had the games. So they just had the flu.
Flu gate all around.
So yeah, that time of year, I reckon.
They were down a long snapper today at ECU football practice.
Oh, yeah, Alex did huge not, news.
Alex did not participate.
Can you ask Coach, are you
I'm going? I'm doing football.
Can
so
you
I,
ask?
I'll ask about Alex being out. Coach, you were down a guy today. It's very important.
How do you even practice without a long snapper? How do you even get anything done?
They have one backup.
Have Tripp Smith snap.
Yep. Do you think they ever considered in the history of football calling the center the short snapper?
That's a good question.
Short snapper is technically
that's for a field goal.
The field goal extra point.
Oh, so there is a technical
short snapper.
I did not know that.
Mm-hmm. Like Colby Garfield was the short snapper last year. He was for
field goals only.
Extra points and field goals.
And extra points, of course, add one to a touchdown,
which makes it seven.
Yeah.
So is Alex both?
He is both.
He can give you the long and short of
He's
it.
He's built differently.
Yeah.
Very good. Very good. Let's take a break. We'll come back. Hour three, Bryce Williams will join us. We'll also tell you about Jersey Mike's Day of Giving.
It's going to make me hungry.
Which is coming up Wednesday, March the 27th. We'll tell you all about that. And more. We've got a giveaway, our Fleet Feet Rundown, Ticket Tuesday. A lot going on. Hour three of Pirate Radio Live. And we'll do it all when we return after this. We've done this before, so you come on in.
Country music artist and comedian Rodney Carrington is coming May 4th to Weldon Mills Theater, Eastern North Carolina's best entertainment venue. Conveniently located just off I-95 in Roanoke Rapids, Weldon Mills Theater offers a hassle-free entertainment experience with free parking, wallet-friendly concessions, and a cozy atmosphere. With comfortable seating throughout the venue, there isn't a bad seat in the house. Join Weldon Mills Theater for a memorable event where you can relax and make lasting memories. Get your tickets for Rodney Carrington on May 4th at WeldonMillsTheater.com.
For the latest from the world of golf, tune in every Saturday morning from 8 to 10 for the Golf Shop Radio Show, presented by PlayGolfMyrtleBeach.com, the golf capital of the world. Hosts Mark Greenhelch and Matt Blanchard talk golf from tee to green and everything in between. If you like golf, you're going to love Golf Shop Radio. Before you tee up, drop on in. Welcome to the Golf Shop.
Turkey, ham, bacon, these and other meats are great around the holidays and every other day, but they all leave behind grease when you cook them, and grease is a real pain in the drain. When you pour grease down a drain, it cools and can clog sewer lines. That can lead to sewer spills, which are messy, bad for the environment, and can also be expensive. Never pour grease down the drain. Instead, collect it in a container like a used soup can or jar. Let it cool and throw it away in the trash. Together, we can protect our sewer system and the environment. For more information, go to GUC.com.
It's time to save at Beauty Bar Medi Spa's Spring Extravaganza, April 8th through the 12th. Mark your calendar, but don't wait for the sale. Schedule your free consultation today to get the inside scoop on all the sale pricing. Your free consultation will allow you to understand your options and plan your budget so you can save on services such as Botox, filler, laser treatments, facials, skincare, and more. Schedule your free consultation and mark your calendar, April 8th through the 12th. BeautyBarMediSpa.com.
Here at Papa John's, we know our stuff.
So try our newest cheesy calzone epic stuffed crust pizza, made with a blend of ricotta and mozzarella, hand-stuffed into that Papa John's fresh, never-frozen original dough. Get it for a limited time only at Papa John's.
Hey, Pirate fans, Papa John's is the MVP move for game day or any day. Place your order online at PapaJohns.com and sign up for Papa Rewards. Papa John's, better ingredients, better pizza. Go Pirates!
Be sure to check out David Price Construction for all of your commercial or custom residential renovation and building needs. Run by ECU alumni, David Price Construction specializes in commercial projects, maintenance on facilities, and large-scale residential renovations and additions. Proud to be voted the remodeler of the year by the Home Builders Association of Raleigh-Wake County in 2018 and Best Business Commercial Remodel Project winner for 2020. David Price Construction, the proud ECU Home Services partner.
This is Brian Harris with 360 Golf Carts, Pitt County's go-to shop for all things golf carts. We have easy-go, club car, and utility carts to choose from. Whether it's for the beach, riding around the neighborhood, or working in the yard, 360 Golf Carts has the perfect ride for you. If you have issues with your current cart, take it by my shop for an expert's diagnosis. From parts to sales to service, we have you covered. We will even deliver right to you. So come see me, Brian Harris, on Highway 43, just past D.H. Conley High School. 360 Golf Carts, Pirates supporting Pirates.
This is Talbot Green with Integrity Home Mortgage. Are you ready and pre-approved if the home you want to purchase comes for sale today? This is a very important step when trying to purchase a home in the current market. Integrity Home Mortgage offers a wide variety of loan programs. Our team of Talbot Green, Braxton Green, and Joanne Weir has over 50 years of experience and is committed to providing you with the superior customer service you deserve.
To get started, call me, Joanne Weir, at 531-1148.
Joanne Weir in MLS 75974. For informational purposes only, Integrity Home Mortgage Corporation is an equal housing lender, NMLS 208516.
This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250 and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930 and 104.1 FM Washington. You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Bud Light, reminding Pirate fans to stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Are you ready and pre-approved if the home you want to purchase comes for sale today? Integrity Home Mortgage offers a wide variety of programs, ranging from conventional, government, and portfolio loans. The Integrity Home Mortgage team of Talbot Green, Braxton Green, and Joanne Weir offers over 50 years of experience and is committed to providing you with the superior customer service you deserve. Call them today at 252-714-2076. Integrity Home Mortgage, Pirates supporting Pirates. Now let's head back in to PRL. Here's Clip.
All right, back with you, Pirate Radio Live, here on a Tuesday, expecting the arrival of Bryce Williams at some point this hour, and we will talk some football because we had ECU Pro Day earlier today. You'll hear what Jalen Johnson and Jeremy Lewis and Julius Wood had to say as they performed in front of NFL scouts. We'll have those interviews for you and some other football talk with Bryce. It is Ticket Tuesday, so coming up later this hour, we will be giving away tickets to ECU and UAB Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Got that coming your way later on in today's show. But right now, we'll tell you about a very special day coming up on Wednesday. Jersey Mike's Day of Giving coming up on Wednesday, and here to talk about it, Wes Shepherd and Elise Ironmonger. And Wes, good to see you again. How you doing, sir?
Hey, doing well. Thanks for having us in today.
Absolutely.
It's been about a year.
Yeah.
Almost, yeah.
We do it every year around this time. And Elise, interesting last name.
Thank you very much.
And I did put together that, so Charlie Ironmonger.
Yes.
Is your betrothed.
Yes. My hubby. Yes. There's not a lot of ironmongers around.
great guy. He has been on Pirate Radio plenty of times.
Yes, yes.
So now you get the spotlight.
I do. Which is fantastic. I do, yep.
And we won't be talking any Seahawks football today.
No, he's the one for that. Yep. I mean, I can talk a little bit. He's the one.
But we will be talking about Jersey Mike's Day of Giving. So, Wes, give us kind of the overview on the Day of Giving. This has been going on for a long time now, 14th annual. Tell us, I guess, how this began and what it is today.
Well, it all starts back with, I guess, Peter Cancro, the owner of the company, way back when. He had an idea, and as long as I've known him, he's been preaching, giving back to the community, preaching. He's been talking about it, talking it up, and he's been right ever since I met him, which has been 30 years ago at this point. But, you know, tomorrow is it's the busiest day. It's our biggest day. We give 100% of our proceeds, not a percentage, not a little bit of this or a little bit of that, but 100% of it goes right back to the Maynard's Children's Hospital here in Greenville, North Carolina. And last year we raised about $141,000. So far we've crested $700,000. We're pushing $1 million. We'd like to get that this year. I don't know if we'll make it, but it's up to our customers. If they come in and they're strong and they don't mind waiting a little bit longer in the lines, possibly, maybe we can hit that $1 million goal this year.
That is fantastic. Do you recommend people maybe ordering online or going into stores, how to treat it differently tomorrow?
If they're going to the store, maybe just wait a little bit, be prepared to wait a little bit, have a little bit more patience. But yeah, you can call in, order online, third party. We'd love to see your face in the restaurant. And if you can't make lunch, come in for dinner. Call ahead today if you want to go ahead and put some catering orders in for tomorrow. Today would be great, a great time to do that. But yeah, we're looking forward to seeing everyone, just like every other year passed. And every year it seems to grow bigger and bigger. Now we have 17 stores that are participating in this, our particular charity with the Maynard's Children's Hospital here. But it should be an exciting day tomorrow, and we're all geared up and got extra food ordered, and we're going to get up bright and early tomorrow. Some stores 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning to bake bread and have everything fresh and ready, as we always do, but just with a little bit longer line possibly. But don't let that deter you. Come on in and know that every dollar, every penny that you bring in and you buy, whether you're buying one sandwich, you're buying 100 sandwiches, all of it stays right here in Eastern North Carolina with Maynard's Children's Hospital.
And Elise, how important is this day for the Maynard's Children's Hospital?
Well, it's incredibly important. You know, we depend on donations like these to support the sick and injured children that are being treated there. And, you know, we're just so grateful for Jersey Mike's and their commitment to the community. You know, there's lots of other partners that do a 10%, 20%, 30%, you know, which is amazing and great. But the fact that Jersey Mike's donates 100% tomorrow is just phenomenal. And, you know, the lucky thing about Children's Miracle Network and, you know, how we support Maynard Children's Hospital is that 100% of what we receive then goes directly to the hospital. And we provide support at all different levels. I mean, we have purchased a whole transport truck. So there's an ambulance that drives around that has the sea creatures and the CMN logo on it. And we were able to purchase that. And it's specifically outfitted to transport these kids, because, you know, we serve 29 counties. If a kid gets sick or injured in the 29 counties in Eastern NC, they're coming to this hospital. And so we have the capabilities of taking that truck out to them and bring them back and to keep them alive and safe as they're transported here. So inside that transport truck is, it's basically a NICU on wheels. So, I mean, if there's a teeny tiny preemie baby all the way up to a teenager, it has all of the equipment, the isolettes, everything to keep them alive and healthy on the way to this hospital. We outfit similar things on the helicopters. I mean, if there's a helicopter, if there's a real critical need, those helicopters have to be outfitted to take care of all sizes of patients. And so we're able to do that through CMN funds. We are able to provide specialized life-saving equipment. One that I, you know, always talk about is our ECMO machine, which is basically a heart and lung bypass that's in our PICU unit. And again, before we purchased that with CMN funds, children had to go over to the Triangle. They had to travel, which again, when these kids are in critical condition, minutes and seconds count. And so now that we have one of those in our unit, that, you know, if their organs are just needing a little time to rest for them to grow and be healthy, they can do that. We support Child Life. Child Life is one of those, units on the hospital that touches every single child that comes in, whether they're coming in through the emergency room, whether they're coming in for a daily infusion, or whether they're there for months at a time. That Child Life staff is there with them through the journey. They're there with the family, the siblings, parents, grandparents, everybody to help kind of process what's going on. So, you know, with these funds, we're able to support them and all that they're doing, bereavement activities, crafts, diversionary experiences. Because again, a lot of these kids, when they come in for different therapies and different scans, they have to be really still. Or again, some of them are there with chronic illnesses and they're there for a really long time. And so to be able to have, you know, Child Life to have those activities and things to normalize the environment, to kind of make it feel like home, you know, anything that we can do that makes it a little bit extra special, a little bit, you know, out of the norm of what the hospital will be able to provide, we're able to do that with these funds.
And that's fantastic. Everybody is going to want a good lunch on Wednesday, so why not get that lunch and help out and do all the great things that Elise was just talking about by going to Jersey Mike's and getting you a sub and helping out on the Day of Giving 14th annual. And once again, does it get bigger and bigger every year, Wes?
Yeah, every year it seems like we're topping the year's number before. And it's even bigger than just Eastern North Carolina. There's over 200 charities coast to coast with Jersey Mike's. I think there's 2,800 stores open now, and they've identified a little over 200 charities. So just because we're doing this here, maybe you're not in North Carolina, but just know if you go to Jersey Mike's anywhere from coast to coast, and now I believe they're in Mexico and Canada too, if you're there too, I'm sure they're doing the Day of Giving as well. But you can go and help a charity anywhere in the country by stopping at Jersey Mike's tomorrow and knowing that 100% of your purchase goes to the charity that that franchisee has chosen.
So no matter where people are listening to right now,
they can
go to their Jersey Mike's tomorrow and help out in a big way. While you're here, you know, we're a sports show, and what Carter Cunningham is doing with the Homers That Help has been fantastic. How about that and his initiative to take that under?
Yeah, and I'm actually the one that's been working with him on that and doing that. And, you know, he came to us and said, I've got this idea. And I was like, okay, let's make it happen. And it's just turned in to this amazing, amazing thing for our community. He's such a great guy, and such a, you know, religious, Christian, wholesome dude, and also apparently hilarious. You know, I've heard some people talk about his walk-up songs that he does and the barter bombs. And but it's been just an amazing kind of combination of, you know, ECU baseball and the Maynard Children's Hospital. And it's just, we've got the best community, both of those combined. We've just got the most generous people that are backing both of us, and it's been really fun. It's different. It's really different, and he had a vision, and working together with him on that has been really, really amazing. And I hope they keep doing it. It's been really fun. I think they're over $15,000 that they've raised right now, and it's phenomenal.
And him doing that, Jersey Mike's doing this, it only leads to more people, I think, giving and having creative ideas and making it fun.
Yes. So. And you know, we're so lucky to have this facility in our backyard in Eastern North Carolina. I mean, it's the top of the top. And again, we're able to keep those pieces of equipment updated, top of the line, to make sure, you know, it's one of those things I always say, I hope no one ever has to use the services of this hospital. But to know that it's there, and that, again, we're going to take the very best care if they're, you know, someone gets sick or someone gets injured, it's there, and it's such a blessing.
Wes, how many locations do we have now in Eastern North Carolina? Well, do you know that number?
I don't know the whole number, but I know we have 17 here in Eastern North Carolina that are participating in the Maynard Children's Hospital with us, and they're in Greenville, Winterville, Washington, Rocky Mount, Goldsboro. I got a list right here if you want to go back and reference it, but the list is long. Yeah. Wilson, Tarboro, just opened up in Williamson, so we're all kind of pitching in, and Jacksonville, if I've forgotten somebody, I'm sorry, but it's 17 stores now.
Wow.
That in our little co-op here that are raising for the cause, and it's exciting.
It's fantastic. Wes, Elise, anything else we need to know?
No, go to Jersey Mike's tomorrow. Yes.
Come tomorrow, bring your wallet, open it up, and give big and give hard.
All right. You know? Wes, good to see you. Thank you so much, and keep up the great work, man.
Thank you. Thanks
great
for
deal.
Having us.
Elise, good to see you. Tell Charlie I said hello.
I will tell him.
All right, good deal. There is Elise Ironmonger and Wes Shepherd joining us here to talk about Jersey Mike's Day of Giving. Go out and buy you a sub tomorrow and help out in a big way. 100% of the sales will be donated to Maynard Children's Hospital. You can learn more at jerseymikes.com/MOG. All right, let's take a break. Bryce Williams will join us. We'll we'll talk some football, and I will also give you some tickets for ECU baseball. Got that coming up at the end of next segment as well. More to go. Pirate Radio Live here on a Tuesday. Back with you after this.
PestTech wants to thank Pirate Nation for voting them the number one pest control company in Eastern North Carolina. PestTech is a full-service pest control company, offering a complete range of indoor and outdoor pest management and extermination services. Your experience is the PestTech guarantee, with a promise to deliver you results while keeping you, your family, and the environment safe. Call the best of the best to get rid of your pests. 353-4760. PestTech, the official pest control company of Pirate Radio.
The convenience of Pitt Greenville Airport is waiting just outside your front door. Service is back, so you're connected to destinations worldwide through flights from American Airlines. Plan your next trip. Book your flights today at flypgv.com or aa.com.
Good news, business travelers. PGV and American Airlines has added a new early morning flight available now. Book today at aa.com and be on time for that connection in Charlotte. Fast, convenient, and close to home, PGV has American flights perfect for your next trip. PGV, where the Pirates fly.
Every March, Jersey Mike's turns money from subs into charitable donations.
And March 27th is Jersey Mike's annual day of giving, where 100% of sales from every sub are given back to the community.
And to kick off all that giving, Peter gave me an apron. I'm honored.
Looking good, Danny. We've got subs to make, though.
Yeah, now I know why you gave me the apron.
Join us Wednesday, March 27th for Jersey Mike's Day of Giving. Be a sub above.
This is your What's New update, brought to you by the new Greenville Auto World. What's new? The new Greenville Auto World has new owners, a state-of-the-art service repair facility that can help you with tires, state inspection, AC repair, and more. Greenville Auto World can work on any type of vehicle and offers great monthly oil change specials. What's new? You making a service appointment now by calling 364-8730. For award-winning service, trust Greenville Auto World, Highway 43 across from the Speedway at Bell's Fork. Pirates supporting Pirates.
I'm Donald Stocks, owner of Pip Marketing Signs Print. We are your one-stop shop for just about anything printed. If we're not your go-to printer, please give us a call at 355-1636. We have over 80 five-star Google reviews and want you to be our next more than satisfied and well-pleased customer. Check us out at growitpip.com or stop in to see us at 3185 Mosley Drive in Greenville. Pip, where business goes to grow.
Hey guys, I've devised a plan to find better home internet. Kids, you scout the web for the best deals. Honey, you monitor our projected data usage.
Or we could avoid that hassle and go with U.S. Cellular's home internet. There's no guesswork, and their internet's faster than ever.
New plan. Ellen, you sign up for U.S. Cellular home internet. Madison, you bring me snacks while I stream the game. Let's do this.
Bundle and save on U.S. Cellular's new and improved home internet. Just $29.99 when bundled with a wireless plan. U.S. Cellular, built for us. Terms apply. Visit uscellular.com for details.
In this new world of having everything delivered to your home or office, why wouldn't you start using Cellular Warehouse for all of your cellular deliveries? Toby Williams and his team are in the business of delivering phones and tablets every day to customers, which enables you to take the hassle out of visiting a store. The best thing about this great service is that it is free. Call Toby Williams today at 252-799-7051 and let his team make your wireless experience fast and easy. Cellular Warehouse, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent.
The brunch is back. The famous brunch buffet at Fifth Street Hardware has a variety of breakfast and lunch items from 10:30 to 2, including an omelet station and prime rib, and a special Sunday cocktail menu, including mimosa flights. Don't forget, Fifth Street Hardware has lunch specials every day, along with over 40 beers on tap. Trivia Wednesday, live music every Thursday night, and a late night menu through the weekend. Visit FifthStreetHardware.com or give them a follow on Facebook and Instagram for a weekly lineup and more. Go Pirates!
Pirate Radio.
I'll give you Blackbeard's honest opinion. You ask me, can this new captain promise you a life of prizes, plunder, and adventure? Aye.
The voice of the Pirate Nation.
If I could write you a song to make you...
You You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Bud Light, reminding pirate fans to stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. The technicians at New Blue stand ready to face any challenge that time or the elements may throw at your home. Your home deserves the best, and New Blue is ready to help with any electrical, plumbing, and HVAC needs. New Blue also now specializes in crawl space, moisture control, and encapsulations, along with septic system repairs and installations. Contact them today at callnublue.com. New Blue Service Group, redefining service excellence. And the Buccaneer Music Hall is your beacon of music in the land of pirates in Eastern North Carolina. They are open 7 days a week with live music every night with the best lineup of bands on the weekends. And ladies, you get in free. Sunday Funday has free pizza all day long with cornhole tournaments starting at 3 o'clock. You can check them out on Facebook and Instagram for the latest. And we'll see you at the Buck. And speaking of the Buck, I have a Buccaneer Music Hall scoreboard update for you as we are heading into the bottom of the fifth inning. East Carolina softball team is leading Elon 5-1. We are just getting the bottom of the fifth underway here.
All right. Hopefully the Pirates can finish out another W on the softball field. Clip Rock, Shirley Rhodes, intern Zach Chan Man, and joining us in the studio, Brian.
I was baptized by the fire in your touch and the flame in your eyes. I'm born to love again. I'm a brand new man.
All right. Everything all right over there, guys?
Gracias, Chan.
No problem, buddy.
We had a bottle failure. I dropped my bottle cap.
Good to have you back, man.
I'm sorry for the absence Tuesday, but I hope you understand.
John Gordon was such a good message that you said, you know, I'm going to take the day off tomorrow.
I'm going to take the day off.
Had the old lady's birthday?
It was 27.
How'd that go?
Good. It was nice. She chose a good tasty meal for her mom to cook, and it was good to celebrate my wife.
My wife. Very good. Very good.
The old ball and chain, as Alex Harper would say.
The old ball and chain.
All right. We got football to discuss with you today, Bryce. Let's start, as we were just talking about it a moment ago, the new NFL rules. And there's a kickoff rule. So during the 2024 season, kickers will continue to kick off from the 35-yard line. But the other 10 players on the kickoff team will line up at the receiving team's 40-yard line. At least 9 members of the return team will line up in the setup zone between the 35 and the 30-yard lines. Up to 2 returners can line up in the landing zone between the goal line and the 20-yard line. No one other than the kicker and returners can move until the ball hits the ground or hits a player inside the landing zone. This sounds like a lot. I am going to try to be optimistic with it and say maybe there will be more kick returns and maybe that play will be exciting again. It really hasn't been that exciting in a while, I feel like. There's a lot of touchbacks and things like that. So, I don't know. It's they're trying to make it safer. I get that. But it is going to look a little funky to see these teams lined up like that.
And I get... I don't get it. You know, the AAF did some crap like that. My thing is, yeah, I do agree where it hasn't really been exciting because you just get touchbacks and it's like, oh, well, okay, that was pointless. If it brings a whole, like if you have to keep the ball in play without a touchback and it has to be returned, then yeah, I feel like it will be more exciting.
I guess, are they keeping the old fair catch? Like at the 5-yard line, a touchback type thing,
right? I'm
assuming that's going to stay in.
Yeah, because if you just kick it and if they just continue to do touchbacks, then nothing's changed.
Touchbacks will be marked on the 30-yard line. No fair catches will be allowed. Okay, there you go.
Okay, so then that way, you know, if the kicker's fairly accurate and kicks it in within the 5,
yeah, we'll have some returns.
Have some returns. So. Yeah, so I guess, but then I guess if he doesn't catch it, lets it go into the end zone, does that mean it's a touchdown?
Touchback, yeah.
Well, thanks. I mean, do you play it as in you – well, I guess if you could do it, they just make it land on, like kick the ball on, like, the 15 or the 20, you know, the 20. I mean, I could see some interesting things coming about there and obviously allow for better field position potentially.
I don't hate this as much as I hate this next thing.
Yeah.
In the event a team wants to attempt an onside kick, it will have to inform officials of its intent.
That
no more surprises.
That is asinine. That's insane.
Hey guys, here's what we're gonna do.
That's crazy.
And you know what? On first down, we're gonna run formation handoff.
I mean, what?
Hey guys, we're about to onside kick this. We want the ball back, but we're basically saying, hey, you get ready so you can have
prepare
the ball
prepare for it.
Like, that's going to be weird if you're the other team, too, and you're like...
But they still have to recover it.
They're telling us to play. Wait, they're not going to do this, are they?
Yeah. But they still have to recover it.
So if you... It's almost like, a comparable thing. Like, is it almost like a balk? Like, you can't fake... Do the whole fake pitch. Like, hey, I'm going to onside, and they prepare for onside.
What happens if you don't?
Yeah. Right.
What's the penalty? I don't know.
Goodness gracious.
Also, Chandler, are they outlawing that tackle?
The
hip drop tackle has been prohibited.
That ended Mark Andrews' season last year.
So, I don't hate this either. I don't know how much this... I feel like this is less avoidable than, say, a horse collar. Because when I grew up watching football, the horse collar was legal.
Yeah.
And then Roy Williams, the Cowboys safety, couldn't freaking tackle anybody. So he'd just ride every player and bring them down with a horse collar and injure half the league. And they were like, all right, maybe we should outlaw this play. Which is a good thing, I think.
Yeah.
Like, but how about this one, Chandler? So explain this play to me.
So... The best thing I can explain.
I'm running with the ball.
You're running with the ball.
Put your arms around me.
I'm coming more at like an angle. So when you look up hip drop tackles in like a highlight film, you're going to see the defender come to the side of the ball carrier and wrap his arms around the hip and then just basically drop, which means the ball carrier is going to awkwardly go down. With their knees folded under them. And if you watch the Mark Andrews tackle, where he got, I think, a torn ACL last year. And I think Tony Pollard got injured with this tackle, too, by the 49ers. I don't know who was the 49ers defender that tackled him. But it's just a technique that I think I've seen. It's a pretty common tackling formation. But I guess they're seeing more and more injuries brought upon the league with this type of tackling. So they're just getting rid of it.
It is going to lead to frustration from fans when a guy makes a seemingly regular tackle and there's going to be a flag.
Yeah, I think it's ridiculous.
It's going to be annoying.
And you know what's already kind of we're seeing with this right now is the body weight on the quarterback.
Yeah.
Like, that's ridiculous to me.
I hate that.
Because that just seems like a normal type of, you know, sack or quarterback gets rid of the ball, a defender hits him, body weight goes on him, flag.
Yeah.
And it just looks normal.
Yeah.
And it's, so that's what's frustrating about it is because it looks normal. You're like, all right, let's play on. No. Flag, they talk about it, it's a 15-yard penalty. So you're going to be seeing that with this hip drop tackle. Because, you know, all offseason, they're going to go into these team meetings and say, all right, this is the new rules, this is how we need to tackle. But it's going to be second nature to these guys, so they're going to make these type of tackles, and here comes the flags.
I think it's ridiculous. I mean, so you're saying for the market, so I'm being a big tight end, so it's like you obviously the best – these DBs, smaller defensive players, obviously going to try to make the best tackle they can with someone who's not a comparable size. So you got a DB coming up and trying to tackle. So Travis Kelce up top, well, that's already a no-brainer. Travis Kelce, if you're going to stiff arm or just the size, and as long as he's going to overpower, he can't make the tackle. And obviously going down to, you know, the feet, that's obviously time and stuff like that. So I think it's absolutely ridiculous. You know, a few of the comments, you know, that J.J. Watt has made, and everybody is quite comical, but I think it's unnecessary.
With these new rules, how are you going to tackle a guy like Derrick Henry?
Exactly. And, I mean, because if you go too low, well, guess what? He's going to jump over you.
He's
going to
drag you across the field.
Right. And you go too high, he's going to get trucked. So,
but if you go right into the middle.
I want to know how many of these people making these rules actually played the game of football at a fairly high level to, like, understand the situation of these things.
They're taking it to the owners, and the owners are saying, are giving them the thumbs up.
Which is, I don't know. It just seems
crazy. They don't want their offensive weapons injured and stuff. Yeah. They want those guys out there playing. It does seem like in my lifetime we've gone from, okay, here is the proper way to tackle, but bottom line, you just bring it down however you can.
Right, exactly.
Now it's, here's the proper way to tackle, and if you do this, 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 and this, you're going to get a flag for it.
Which is crazy.
You've already seen frustration across the league from current players and former players about, in 10 years it's going to be flag football, and it's heading into the wrong direction. Yeah. And so we'll see how it goes this upcoming football season, but it's going to be weird whenever you see a regular tackle a flag.
Exactly. So, and then it's like, what's the percentage of the hip drop tackle causing an injury?
How are you going to tell between a hip drop tackle and just a regular tackle?
Right.
Is what I'm thinking. Mm. Because they even went to, like, all right, so I saw today, like, the DK Metcalf, like, the famous, it was intercepted at the goal line, and DK Metcalf chased the guy down. I think it was Buda Baker.
Yeah.
He chases him from behind and reaches for him and grabs him by the hip and then drops like this. So that's a flag.
Yeah. So he saves a touchdown, and then they get 15 on top, whatever. Yeah. Much it's called.
He tackles them at the 20, but they're going to get the ball at the 5.
Right. It's crazy. I think it's absolutely ridiculous. But
well, there you go. It's
the bystander. There's bystander.
No D on the end. Yeah. ED. Shirley, we need to take a break, and we need to give away some tickets. What caller do you want to do here? I asked her the toughest question she's ever been asked in her life. Sim. 317-1250. Do you want tickets to see East Carolina play UAB Thursday, Friday, and Saturday? We will hook you up. Toby Williams, Sailor Warehouse.
He'll bring them to you.
Are hooking you up with Ticket Tuesday. He's going to bring them right to you. Thanks to Toby Williams, he and his team are in the business of delivering phones and tablets every day to customers, which enables you to take the hassle out of visiting the store. The best thing about this great service is that it's free. Call Toby Williams, 252-799-7051. Let his team make your wireless experience fast and easy. Sailor Warehouse, your local U.S. Sailor authorized agent. Want some baseball tickets? Call in now, 317-1250. We'll have our winner. More with Bryce Williams, and we'll recap Pro Day on our Fleet Feet Rundown when we return after this.
Here with Jeff Stein at Brown & Wood, it's a great time to buy a used vehicle.
It's not a great time, it's a perfect time to buy a used car from Brown & Wood. We have over 115 used vehicles in stock, and we're number one in the market on price. We have limited lifetime powertrain on all of our used cars under 80,000 miles, so go to brownandwoodauto.com to find out more. 4 brands, 3 generations, 2 rooftops, and 1 goal, to make sure you leave a happy customer.
And then it was Tuesday!
We're here for the booty.
Party!
Pirate Water is here. Go to drinkpiratewater.com to find Pirate Water in a location near you.
We're going planking!
Pirate Water is here. 21 and older, please drink responsibly.
Hey, Pirate fans, this is Coach Cliff Godwin. The physicians at Orthopedics East and Sports Medicine Center have been caring for our athletes at ECU for more than 35 years. Whether it's treatment for our sports injury or it's time for that joint replacement, Orthopedics East provides the latest in operative and non-operative orthopedic care, physical therapy, and diagnostic testing. For experienced and professional services, call the team at Orthopedics East at 252-757-2663 or visit them online at OrthoEast.com. Go Pirates!
Okay, guys, I've devised a plan to find better home internet. Kids, you scout the web for the best deals. Honey, you monitor our projected data usage.
Or we could avoid that hassle and go with U.S. Cellular's home internet.
New plan. Ellen, you sign up for U.S. Cellular home internet. Madison, you bring me snacks while I stream the game.
Bundle and save on U.S. Cellular's new and improved home internet. Just $29.99 when bundled with a wireless plan. U.S. Cellular, built for us.
This is Brandon Tate, owner and operator of Atlantic Wireless, an authorized agent for U.S. Cellular since 1997. Visit AtlanticWireless.com.
CoachCliff.com to find the store near you. We go beyond the call.
Greenville's hometown pizzeria is Cucinella's. Cucinella's has two locations with great options for lunch, dinner, takeout, and they now offer catering. Dine in for lunch with a slice, salad, and a drink with a friend, or stop by after work and grab a beer or glass of wine while you wait for your to-go order. The best pizza, grinders, salads, and homemade Italian ice is at Cucinella's. Cucinella's Midtown across from Best Buy, downtown across from Sup Dogs, and on Facebook and Instagram. Cucinella's, serving handcrafted pizza since 1932. Come taste the difference.
East Coast Grading and Utilities is your source for clearing, hauling dirt, and concrete work. East Coast Grading and Utilities handles all sewer and water issues as well.
I'm David Vaughn. Whether it's putting in a new subdivision or helping you with any and all of your drainage problems, I can get the job done. Call me at 531-7494.
No job is too big or too small. East Coast Grading and Utilities. Friends helping friends. 531-7494. For East Coast Grading and Utilities. Utilities.
Bostic Sugg Furniture is proud to be the Greenville area's exclusive retailer of Lux Living and Bob Timberlake American Home. Elevate your home with beautiful Lux Living custom order sofas, chairs, and sectionals. Experience the elegant designs of Bob Timberlake's solid cherry furniture from the only dealer in North Carolina. Take an extra 10% off or get up to 48 months special financing. Lux Living, Bob Timberlake American Home, exclusively at Bostic Sugg Furniture.
Welcome to Russell's Spring Style. Our screen door shouts welcome to a beautiful selection of new apparel for men and women. The spring colors are fresh and beautiful, just in time for Easter. Men, the store is full of new sports coats and in-house alterations assure a great fit. Ladies, it's Russell's for the best selection of dresses, whether long or short. Rhonda and her team work hard to make Russell's in downtown Washington your shopping destination. It's all about you, our pirate friends and customers at Russell's Clothing.
Pirate Radio. We work like captains.
And I'm your pirate captain. You are going to put on your dancing shoes and rock it.
And party like pirates.
I was doing just fine before I met you. I drink too much and that's an issue. I'm okay.
You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Bud Light, reminding pirate fans to stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Do you want to get rid of wrinkles, tighten and lift your skin, smooth your skin texture, erase veins and brown spots, and get rid of unwanted hair? Are you interested in Botox or filler? Contact the licensed professionals at Beauty Bar Medi Spa on Red Banks Road in Greenville. Free consultations available by calling 752-1406 or visiting beautybarmedispa.com. Enjoy your visit. Love your transformation. And congratulations to Greg Davis, our big winner today on our Ticket Tuesday, brought to you by Cellular Warehouse. And a quick Buccaneer Music Hall scoreboard update. East Carolina up to bat right now in the bottom of the, I got to count here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bottom of the sixth, runners on first and second. Score is 5-1, East Carolina. Now back to you, Clip.
All right, back with you, Pirate Radio Live. Mac McCarthy has recognized that he left his glasses and said he would pick them up tomorrow. So do we have those readily available in our lost and found section? All right, good.
What is over there in the lost and found? A glass, a...
That's like some WD-40.
Oh, what is that? I
need that's
tape.
That is my workbench over there. So when that's things Shirley's break around bench. Here, I fix it.
When he gets you a work shop light, a pegboard.
Well, I mean, I...
A tool.
I had an area where I kept all of my tools in one spot, but... For some reason, they keep getting moved from room to room to room in this building. Mm. And when I go looking for things, they disappear.
You don't touch people's tools.
Yeah, I have.
Don't touch my tools.
Look, dude, I've been here. This is my 21st year. I don't understand how it happens all the time.
Mm. We need to put a camera up.
There may be a come to Jesus meeting coming soon.
Y'all want things fixed? Don't touch my D tools. You know,
that would be a good country song if it's not already
Don't touch my D tools.
to the
don't touch my details.
I done told you once.
I done told you once. I won't tell you twice. Yeah.
Otherwise, I hit you with a hammer.
Don't touch my vice.
I'm sure you and now John can come up with
something. I think we can.
There we go.
I didn't tell you one. I didn't tell you two. Please, God, don't touch my tools.
I think we do it starting with the kid growing up, and he touched his grandfather's tool and realized he shouldn't have done
son,
that.
Hey, son, don't touch my tool.
And then
he finds himself strapped to a chair, and somebody's got a pair of pliers in their hand.
It goes to another generation of him explaining to his son.
And why you don't touch the tools.
And then at the end, it's... And I heard my boy tell his boy, don't touch my D-tools. There you go. And we just made a hit. That's how it's done. All right, Fleet Feet Rundown brought to you by Fleet Feet, located 207 East Arlington Boulevard in the Old Gordon's Golf location. They will find the right shoe for you with their great one-on-one service, the 3D foot scanner, and everything they have to offer over there at Fleet Feet. And today, we were out watching some Pro Day. And I got a chance to talk to some now former Pirates who are trying to make it on the next level. Shirley, let's start with Jalen Johnson. We talked to him first today, ECU wide receiver, as we recapped his pro day.
Jalen, how do you think it went out there today, man?
Felt like it went smooth, you know. Went out there, ran some crisp routes, caught everything. Just wanted to show my ability to get out of breaks, make sure I can catch everything, finish strong.
So do you work out in Georgia too?
Yes, sir.
Did more of the testing there.
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel like it went there and then kind of combined that with today?
It went good at Georgia. I put up some solid numbers, 40 yards. Some teams had me like high 4.3, low 4.4. So me and my agent, my family, we talked, just said that just focus on position drills here since we did the testing.
What type of feedback are you getting from scouts at this point just on how you've done everything?
They tell me I did a real good job. A lot of them were at Georgia too. They told me that they're going to be here to see me here too. They just wanted to see me run good routes, catch everything, look strong. And a lot of them gave me good feedback, positive feedback, said they like my game.
How does it feel to perform for scouts? I know this is probably part of the dream, a step in the dream.
For sure. It's definitely part of the dream. Just growing up, always wanted to go to the NFL. Always looked forward to this. You know, I didn't get a combine invite, but that's just how the life goes. I know everybody gets a pro day. I just wanted to come out here, show these scouts that I'm one of those guys that they can count on and call to be on the team.
Jalen, what are NFL teams getting out of you as a player?
They're getting a complete player, someone who's willing to do anything that helps the team out, whether it's blocking, catching, special teams. I can do it all. I'm a real coachable guy. I'm a good teammate. I'm always a good presence in the locker room. I feel like I can really help add to the team.
Very different type of training you go through for Pro Day. How'd that kind of play in today? Was there something we were working on outside of what we were doing for today? What was that going on?
It's different just because there's no, like, schedule. You know, when you play college football, as you know, we've got meetings every day at a certain time, practice a certain time, certain drills. So it's a lot. It's a mental battle. Got to stay disciplined. I was out there just working on my explosiveness, anything that gets me faster, making sure I'm taking care of my body and doing a lot of receiving training just to sharpen up those things that I didn't have the time to work on in season maybe or at every practice.
You had some former teammates, Holton, Isaiah, Noah, getting ready to play football this weekend in the UFL. Are you NFL or bust, or are you willing to go these other routes if it comes to that?
No, I mean, I was a zero star at high school, so I'd be a fool to say I'm NFL or bust. So I'm willing to, anybody who wants to take a chance on me, I'm willing to take it and play it for any league.
There is Jalen Johnson earlier today out at Pro Day, and as I said, he does have some teammates who will be on TV this weekend playing some football, and he's leaving that option open. Bryce, what is this day? It's a pretty stressful day for these guys. What was it like for you?
No, I mean, definitely there was some, you know, some nerves, you know, internal nerves, just because, you know, you know, what's at stake, you know, if you don't perform well. But then, you know, at the end of the day, it's trust, as Coach Ruff would say, trust your training. You know, we've been playing the sport for a long time. You know, obviously it was easier doing your blocking and your routes and, you know, the football aspect of this pro day and stuff and the weightlifting and things like that. But, you know, obviously they sometimes hone in on the three cone drill, the short shuttle, the daggum 40 yard dash and things like that. But like I said, just trust your training. It's fun. It is a great experience. And, you know, you're always hopeful. You know, if you feel like you've put on a good pro day or, you know, combine, either one, you just sort of hope for the best. And, you know, it is an exciting journey.
Well, we'll hear Julius Wood talk about it, but he talked about how he's a football player and loves football. And this has been different because he's training for things he really hasn't trained for, you know, during his football career.
Yeah.
And how he had to get used to that. Did say it was fun. Also, Julius had a long conversation with a couple of scouts and kind of asked them about that, and we'll play it in a moment. But how much did scouts want to talk to you, like, one-on-one to get to know who you were? Was that more for, I guess, if you get invited somewhere or something? Like,
yeah, I did mainly had a lot of conversations, you know, through phone calls and things.
Right.
Scouts from different teams would call at the combine, senior bowl. You know, you'll talk with position coaches, combine. They do want to get to know you.
Not so much on pro day, though?
No, not really for me on pro day. Maybe they kind of already knew
what
they had through the senior bowl and combine stuff. But going back to what you say about the Julius Wood saying he's a football player and training for these, you know, drills that, you know, look at game film, look how I move. That tells the tale.
Yeah.
How fast to do a three cone or a short shuttle. You know, I'm never going to be in that position. I mean, maybe I like if I catch the ball and stumble, but like that's just bracing yourself. The whole short shuttle, you know, when you're in that, like, I guess you call it like a Spider-Man touch there or run around in a triangle. I don't know when you're really going to do that. You know, my routes will tell how well I do, how well I separate from a defender, blocking, you know, same things with that. And then obviously Julius Wood, you know, being a defensive guy, how he flips his hips, you know, with the running back coming out of the backfield or, you know, a tight end coming across the field. The film tells everything.
Yeah.
I mean, it's part of the deal. I guess with pro day and the combine and all these drills, I guess you really wouldn't have a combine if you didn't do these drills. But that's, I don't know.
Let's hear what Julius Wood had to say about it as we talked to him after today's pro day workouts.
How do you think it went?
I think it went good. You know, prepared a long time since late December for this moment, and I feel like it went good today out here. You know, I feel like I checked off a lot of boxes and showed a lot of teams, you know, what I'm all about. So, you know, it's time for the next step and time to go get what I feel like I deserve.
You've always said, you know, tape kind of speaks for itself. So you know, how confident are you in that aspect of the game more so than anything that even happens out here?
My tape, yeah, definitely speaks for itself. You know, at the end of the day, I'm a football player. So, you know, I pride myself on playing football. You know, it was a great opportunity to be out here, you know, doing drills and running a 40-yard dash, you know. But at the end of the day, you know, you're not running drills in the football game. You playing football. So, you know, I'm a football player, and I've always been that since a young kid. I like to play football, you know. So when I went off to training, it was kind of a little bit weird because I'm used to playing football. So I got to, you know, go all in on training and stuff. And it was a great thing to do out there in Nashville, Tennessee at X3. You know, I met a lot of good people and just built a lot of good relationships with people, you know, that I'll never forget. And it was a good opportunity to come out here today and, you know, showcase my abilities and things like that. So I feel like I did good. I feel like I showed what I needed to show. You know, I could have did better in things, you know, but that's always the case. You know, that's life. But, you know, I gave it my all in. I feel like I made a statement for sure.
Any conversations as to where you project in the next level inside the box, playing back half of safety, what they say?
You know, teams got me different teams got different schemes. So some teams say they like me in the box strong. Some teams like me free safety. You know, so I'm a versatile player. You know, I can play many different roles. You know, that's one thing about me playing football. You can put me wherever, I'm going to make plays, you know. So I pride myself on that. Like, football, that's what I do, you know. So anywhere you put me on the field, nose guard, I'm making plays. So it don't matter where I'm at, I'm making plays.
You had some long conversations with a couple of scouts. Are they talking football? Are they talking off the field stuff? What are they asking you when you talk to them?
You know, they want to get to know you a little bit. They want to get to put a voice on the face and things like that. So get a little bit about your character and things like that. And, you know, they ask you a lot of different questions, you know, but I always did good with interviews and things like that. So, you know, it's on my mind. You know, I don't have to really practice for an interview or anything. You know, I'm a good communicator. So I can have a conversation. We're just having a conversation. So, yeah, I done got a whole bunch of questions, and, you know, I just do a good job answering them, you know, getting to know people, and that's what it's all about.
You said it went well. What was the experience like for you today, getting to go through this pro day?
It was a real good experience, you know. Like I said, it was different because, you know, usually you out here playing football, but it was a different experience. You know, I feel like it was an experience that I grew, you know, to end up loving while I was training in Nashville and, you know, just building them relationships and things like that. It was a different experience because this is a process, you know, that's, you know, you're getting judged off of something that's something that's like drills and how far you can jump and things like that. So, you know, you want to do your best and things like that. So I feel like I feel like I did good today, you know. I feel like I could have did better on things, but, like, you know, I'm grateful for everything. You know, I thank God, you know, just for waking me up. So you just got to be grateful for wherever you at, you know, and just, you know, play the hand you dealt. So I feel like I got a good deck of cards with me, and I did my thing, and I'm ready for the next step.
What are NFL teams getting out of you as a player?
They getting a real versatile, good character man. You know, I'm a family man. You know, I'm a tremendous football player, a leader, somebody that younger guys look up to. You know, someone who's just good energy, good character, somebody who lifts up the locker room, lifts up people around them, try to speak a positive affirmation on people around them, and just all-around good person, you know. Yeah, that's what they're going to get out of me, a hard worker, relentless, and somebody who's going to be a ball player for a real long time.
What teams have consistently kind of shown interest in the pre-draft process?
The Chargers, the Raiders, Cincinnati Bengals, Detroit Lions, Houston Texans, San Francisco, Chicago Bears, a good handful. I mean, I could keep going. You know, it'd be kind of hard to go off the head. It's hard for real to remember everybody, but a good amount of teams, you know, and I'm excited, you know, just for the opportunity to be able to talk to that many teams, you know, so.
There is Julius Wood from earlier today, and hopefully he gets a look with the team and can live out his dream of playing in the NFL. Had a good really came on the scene a couple years ago for East Carolina, and led the team in tackles last season. Bryce Williams joining us. Let's take a break. When we return, we'll have our Pirate Radio Outdoors update and more with Bryce as we wrap up this Tuesday edition of Pirate Radio Live. Back with you after this.
Doing just fine before I met you. Drink too much and that's an issue. Okay.
Golden Ticket Cinemas is Greenville's newest movie theater and is now open in the Greenville Grand location on Greenville Boulevard near Cracker Barrel. Experience the ultimate movie magic with their Elite experience. The Elite Theater has the largest screen in Greenville, state-of-the-art 4K laser projection, immersive Dolby Atmos sound, and heated luxury recliners. And coming soon, Eastern North Carolina's only IMAX theater. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show in style with luxurious amenities and top-notch service at Golden Ticket Cinemas.
What's even better than going to Jimmy John's? The great taste of Jimmy John's coming to you. Check out their convenient catering bundle, including a 12-pack of half sandwiches made with fresh baked bread, hand-sliced meats, and fresh veggies, plus two premium sides, 15 chips, and 15 desserts, all for one great price. You can also choose an a la carte option. Pick it up, or they'll set it up for you. And don't forget Jimmy John's loyalty app with a free sandwich after your first visit. Jimmy John's in Greenville and Wilson, and online at jimmyjohns.com.
Are you struggling with weight loss? It might be 15 pounds or 115 pounds. It seems like losing weight involves too much exercise and not enough food. Well, no more. Semaglutide is an FDA-approved treatment offered by ArcPoint Labs. Dr. John Bruce, a board-certified bariatric surgeon, will consult and oversee your entire weight loss journey. Transform yourself and get ready for the beach next summer. This program is safe, cost-effective, and has a physician oversight. Call ArcPoint Labs today at 514-8049.
Your first stop for shopping is at Shimmer Boutique.
This is Ashley from Shimmer. We are fully stocked with the latest apparel, shoes, and accessories, and more. If you need gift ideas or some shopping therapy for yourself, stop by today. Looking for the hottest shoes on the market? Shimmer has the biggest selection of Hey Dudes anywhere. Shimmer has the newest Yeti products and colors. Want this year's most popular bag? Shimmer has a great selection of all your bog bag needs and accessories. Shimmer in Greenville, Winterville, and Jacksonville.
The wait is over. DraftKings Sportsbook, an official sports betting partner of NASCAR, is now live in North Carolina. Now you can legally bet on all your favorite sports anytime, anywhere, right here in North Carolina with DraftKings. For a limited time, new customers who sign up with the promo code PIRATE and bet $5 will receive $250 instantly in bonus bets. DraftKings has the best features, including same-game parlays, player props, and more, with fast and easy payouts right at your fingertips. Get ready for the NCAA tournament with DraftKings. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app now using the code PIRATE and bet $5 to get $250 instantly in bonus bets. Only on DraftKings Sportsbook with the code PIRATE. The crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov. 21 plus, North Carolina only. Bonus bets expire 168 hours after issuance. Deposit and eligibility restrictions apply. Terms at DraftKings.com/sportsbook/NC. NASCAR is not a sponsor of this promotion and used under license.
Do you ever talk to yourself about where to eat today and then you hear
Warren's Hot Dogs?
Then you're thinking, yeah, two hot dogs, chips and a drink for only $6.25 would be awesome.
Warren's Hot Dogs.
And maybe some homemade lemonade, perhaps a pizza or a sub, and definitely an apple or peach turnover.
Warren's Hot Dogs.
Don't overthink where to eat today. Go to Warren's Hot Dogs in Greenville across from Ron Ayers or in Chocowinity next to the fire station. Warren's Hot Dogs, serving the Pirate Nation since 1991. Go Pirates!
This is Brian Harris with 360 Golf Carts, Pitt County's go-to shop for all things golf carts. We have easy-go, club car, and utility carts to choose from. Whether it's for the beach, riding around the neighborhood, or working in the yard, 360 Golf Carts has the perfect ride for you. If you have issues with your current cart, take it by my shop for an expert's diagnosis. From parts to sales to service, we have you covered. We will even deliver right to you. So come see me, Brian Harris, on Highway 43, just past D.H. Conley High School. 360 Golf Carts, Pirates supporting Pirates.
This is retired ECU baseball player Charlie Jorgen, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. This hour of PRL is brought to you by Bud Light, reminding Pirate fans to stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates, and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. It was another down day for the stock market. The Dow was down 31 points at 39,282. The NASDAQ was down at 68 at 16,315, and the S&P was down 14 at 5,203. That's your Wells Fargo Advisors Stock Market Report. For a personal look into investing, call Wells Fargo Advisors today at 756-6900 in Greenville. Wells Fargo Advisors LLC, member SIPC. And a Buccaneer Music Hall scoreboard update. East Carolina Run Rules Elon. They win it 9-1. So keeping that winning streak going there for East Carolina. So two games in a row, and then they are on the road coming up this weekend.
Pirates are hot. Congratulations, Coach Winkler and his softball team. All right, we got a few minutes left. Just enough time to get a Pirate Radio Outdoors update with Bryce Williams and see what he's been up to on the water and in the field. Excuse me, in the woods. And let's bring in another one of our
Look who it is.
Our outdoorsman. Young Joey in the house. Bryce, what's been going on?
I'm trying to think back 2 weeks ago, because obviously I missed there. What was 2 weeks ago? I'm trying to remember what I did 2 weeks ago. That was kind of a long time.
I'm going to say you fixed your boat a little bit.
I think I did something. I'm going to say I fished something 2 weeks ago before Anna's birthday. Where was I? I'm just going currently. Well, this weekend we did some traveling. We were down in Florida for a little bit. So I guess you could say I was just sort of on the leisure side of the outdoor world.
Okay.
By the ocean and all that stuff. Nothing too crazy. Just a little more of a, what's it called? Not TLC.
R&R?
R&R. There we go.
Did you get any TLC?
No, I did not.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, R&R this past weekend, and I want to say the other weekend I fished, but I couldn't tell you. So, no, just something subtle this time, but hopefully we can get some more exciting things. You know, turkey season is literally, I think, just a little hair of over 2 weeks away.
All right.
So, started to do some scouting in there, and get me some new camo today. I'm joining the old Sitka gang.
Okay.
Which is just
unfamiliar.
It's just a brand of
it's camo. A brand.
So
it's, all right.
Yeah. So it's about time for some new camo today. So I'll be having a new sweet. I'm gonna look real good, and I'm hoping if I look good, I can hunt good.
There you go.
So that is actually what's been popping. That's the biggest news that was today.
All right. Other big news. Joey cut his hair.
Yeah,
Joey.
What's up,
Joey? Hair.
What's up? How you guys doing?
Good. Joey smells good.
Does he?
Oh, appreciate it.
Man, you're a good smelling fella.
And you got one of them shirts, and I don't.
A little
pirate towel.
I don't know. Are they ad? Are they advertisement?
No.
Honorary.
Pirate towel.
Pirate towel. Okay. Yeah. Call Joey.
Yeah.
Nice shirt. I need to get one of them.
Yeah. Is that a shirt or a sweatshirt, Clip?
That's a sweatshirt.
Sweatshirt.
It's a shirt at the end of the day.
That is true. The last word is shirt.
It's a shirt.
Shirt.
Yeah. What's up?
Clip's never wrong.
Did something happen?
What's up, brother?
What's up,
brother? How you doing, brother?
Hey, brother.
No.
Did you do anything outdoor? Is that you came in during this segment? Did you do anything or just saying
that? Pescado.
Let's see. Outdoors.
Is that a word?
Yeah, pescando. Yeah, of course. The only thing I didn't hunt the crab that I'm going to cook this afternoon. So yeah. That's something, right? Outdoors.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, most
definitely. I got it from a seafood market.
You had to go outside to a seafood market. Exactly. The fish, the crab were caught outside. I tell you, it's all correlated.
I actually walked to the seafood market
there
from my apartment.
Go.
So I said that's outdoorsy.
Market. Where's the seafood market here?
The one that's like right off of First Street next to the mini golf.
Mm. You're going to have to show me.
All right. I'll take that off
here. Or tell me the name of it.
He'll walk you there.
It just says seafood market. That's the thing.
Joey, good to see you.
Good to see you, too.
Bryce, enjoyed it as always.
Thanks for having me.
That was a really fast... Which you were out the first segment.
Yeah.
But it still went really fast.
Yeah, that was good.
All right. Well, I'll see you next week.
That's right.
All right. We'll see you fine folks on Wednesday, 3 o'clock, for an all-new edition of Pirate Radio Live. Planning to talk to the ECU tight ends coach, Hunter McKay.
Mm.
So if you got a tight ends coach question, I'll text you tomorrow. Oh, I need a question or two to ask him. Holt Naylor is going to join us as well, along with Ken Watlington, P. Mace, and the Wednesday crew. We will talk to you then. For Shirley Rhodes, Chon, Young Joey.
Yes, brother.
B-Dub, I am Clip Rock. Jeff Charles, take us home.
Have a great night, Eastern Carolina.
Thanks for listening to Pirate Radio Live, an exclusive presentation.